Scriptures talk about a blessedness that happens to a man whose delight is in the law of God. So as someone says, it says, but his delight is in the law of God, and doth he meditate day and night. He says that that man is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whose leaves do not wither, and who bears fruit in every season. As you are about listening to this message, we believe that your life is going to be like that man planted by the rivers of water. Your leaves are forever going to bear. And we know that your season will not pass by. You will forever shine and you will forever bear fruit. We have a lot of content to share with you. So we would entreat you to subscribe to this channel, as well as like us. Hit that notification bell to receive more updates from us, because we know that whatever content here is going to set you on course at every time. It's going to make you attain whatever stature that Christ wants you to attain. Thank you.
People, 11 people that I see, and God is breaking afflictions in families. 11 people at the count of three, the power of God will move inside and outside. There are some of you who are outside right now. 11 people, Lord, let your power touch those people right now. 11 of them I see in the spirit. There's one person I see, someone at the outside at the overflow. The power of God is coming upon that one person. No other name like the name of Jesus. There's no other name like the name of the Lord. No other name like the name of Jesus. He's worthy of glory. He's worthy of honor. Sing it from the depths of your heart. There's no other name like the name of Jesus. There's no other name like the name of the Lord. There's no other name like the name. Hallelujah. Visit us tonight, oh God. Do what only you can do. Let your people know that you are in the midst of your people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Please be seated. God bless you. I welcome everyone tonight. We apologize for those of us outside. I want you to know that no matter how far you are, the Lord will touch you this night. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You have not come to seek an idol. You have come to seek the living God. Hallelujah. One of the things that the Lord has been doing and will keep doing in this place is revealing to us the mysteries of the kingdom. Everyone say the mysteries of the kingdom. The Bible says it has been given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom. The Lord declared that this is our year of light and dominion. dominion that comes through light, not guesswork. Dominion that comes through understanding. Psalm 82 from verse 5 says, they know not, neither will they understand. And so they grope in darkness and the earth is out of course. Said, but have I not said, ye are gods? Are you following me now? And all of you are children of the Most High. He said, but you shall die like mere men and fall like one of these princes. The advantage you have in the kingdom, listen to me, the advantage you have in the kingdom is not just that you have declared the lordship of Christ over your life, but you have come to a point where you have spiritual understanding. You understand how this system functions. And then the things that used to be a mystery are no longer a mystery to you, because you know that there is an operation that governs them. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, what you know in the kingdom stays with you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When you know it, he said they are life to those who find them. That means they sought for it. They are life to do, not to everybody. They are not life to every Christian. They are life to those who find them. And health to their flesh. And so as God opens our eyes to see these things in the spirit, we must be passionate about making them part of our lives. The question is, how many of us are really willing to apply the things we are hearing? The issue with the body of Christ may not necessarily be lack of revelation, but our inability to take the word of God and make it become part of our life in truth. Oh Lord, I want to know your glory. I want to offer a sacrifice of praise. Fill this temple, Lord, with your spirit. Ephesians chapter 3. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Again, we welcome those of us who have come from far. May the Lord bless you. Your life will never be the same in the name of Jesus. Verse 9. Ephesians chapter 3. From verse 9. By the way, let me appreciate as many of us who were able to embark on the fast. I know that some of us didn't fast. Praise the Lord. But for as many of us who opened up ourselves, the Bible says, he that sows to the flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he that sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap life everlasting. It says, do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. Men can be mocked, but God cannot be mocked. Whatsoever a man sows, he will reap. Hallelujah. Whatsoever a man sows, that man will reap. We are sowing to the Spirit. And we understand that there is a reward. Say, there is a reward. Say it one more time, there is a reward. Brothers and sisters, not everything in the kingdom is a gift. Not everything in the kingdom is a gift. There are certain things that are rewards. If everything in the kingdom is a gift, what then is the reward of obedience? Hallelujah. It says, there remained a rest for the people of God. although they are the people of God, there still remaineth a rest. It says, let us labor to enter that rest. For he that has entered that rest has ceased from his works. Hallelujah. So I want to really salute every one of us. I know for many of us, doing a dry fast like that may not be very, your body, because you are living in the body, may not be easy. But you see, his strength is made perfect in our weakness. Hallelujah. It doesn't kill. Don't let any man fool you. It does not kill. It does something to you in the spirit that until you are spiritually minded, you may never understand. You see, I keep saying it. If I ask this sister to stand where you are, without telling her the reason why she should stand, and the benefit, whatever she will gain for standing, she will be wary. Are you getting my point? And there's every tendency that she will compromise. But if I tell her, stand here, because somebody is about to pass, let him locate you and bless you. Even when she's tired, there is a higher revelation that is beyond the pain of her body, and it keeps her. This is the revelation that makes men spiritual. So although your body is weak, Paul says, so then death works in us, that life may work in you. Physically speaking, your body is weak. You see everything and you want to take it, even if it is Vicks Lemon Plus or what, you just want to take anything that can help you. The clearest proof of obedience is when you have the opportunity to disobey. That's when your obedience is perfected. If I rob you of an opportunity to obey and I don't give you an option, you are not really obedient. That's why there was another tree in the Garden of Eden, so that the will of man could freely choose. Hallelujah. I salute every one of you. May God bless us. We will reap the benefit for sure. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let me also use this opportunity to salute all of the workers. I was just thinking about the workforce we have in this ministry. Believe me, you may not understand the enormous responsibility that working in this ministry entails. You must love God to be a faithful worker. They are bounded by love. And I can only imagine trying to do all of the things they are doing while praying and fasting, complete dry fast. The Lord will honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. My Bible tells me that God is no man's debtor. He will reward you your labor of love. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Out of the ashes of my dying today, I see the breaking of a brand new day, in which the name of the Lord alone is glorified. I see the breaking of a brand new day. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 3 is where we are. Verse 9. It's projected so we can just look to save time. And to make all men see what is the what? Of what? It says the fellowship of the mystery. To make men see what is the fellowship, the resultant effect of our partaking in the knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom, which from the beginning of the world had been hid in God, who created all things by Jesus Christ. Verse 10. To the intent, that means this is why he's now revealing to us the mystery, that now unto principalities and powers in heavenly places might be known by the church the multifaceted wisdom of God. That means that the wisdom of God is shrouded in mysteries. And every time God wants to display new dimensions of himself, he opens people. He grants them access to the mysteries of the kingdom. Take all of me, Lord. You have my everything. Use all of me, Lord. I give all of me, Lord. You have my everything. Take all of me, Lord. Anoint my everything. Use my everything. I release my everything. You have my everything. Take all of me, Lord. You have my everything. Take all of me, Lord. Brothers and sisters, we reign in this kingdom on the strength of our knowledge of the mysteries. Hallelujah. Dominion is not an impartation. Dominion is not about claiming, I take it. No. Dominion is the resultant effect of the spiritual understanding of this system. The laws that have been put in operation. Hallelujah. And how to be able to walk with these laws to ensure that the kingdom of God comes across a territory. So dominion has nothing to do with just trying to claim. It's not about jacking yourself and trying to believe. When Jesus walked upon the earth, every time he looked at things, he interpreted them on the strength of his knowledge about the mysteries of the kingdom. When he saw the winds and the waves, he didn't join the other people to say, I think we're in rainy season. He looked well and he said, no, this is demonic. Are you getting what I'm saying now? All through the Bible, all those who were able to, by reason of some spiritual means, have access to the mysteries of the kingdom, they were the ones who reigned in their generation. Isaac understood something about spiritual laws. And when men were running away for famine, he sowed in that land. And he reaped a hundredfold. Hallelujah. The Bible says the Philistines envied him. He increased, he worked strong, he made progress. Moses had an encounter and there was something that Moses knew. He knew that his rod was the rod of God and that that rod could do mighty things. Brothers and sisters, those who will be featured in this end time move of God are not just men who say, God, use me. They are men who will have to understand the ancient keys that kept the heavens and the earth closed and that opened them at will. If you do not understand this key, you will die like a merman. The world is becoming spiritual every day. I hope you realize. It used to be physical when giants and great men will threaten others. Then it now became intellectual. Hallelujah. So your dominion is on the strength of your knowledge of intellect and having knowledge of your biological environment and so on and so forth. But before Christ comes, it is they that know their God. They that know is the same word know, like a man knowing a woman. They that have come into practical intimacy, that has proofs. They that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. I don't want to live my life guessing, hoping I'm right, hoping that the laws of the spirit that are being operated are the correct ones, only to find out that it's not like that. The Bible says, awake thou that sleepest, and Christ will give you light. He said, walk circumspectly, as wise, not as unwise. In the days that will come, hear me, those that do not understand the mysteries of the kingdom will die like men. But they looked at Paul and Barnabas and they said, the gods have come to us. They called them the Greek gods, Zeus and Hermes, because oh my God, look at the Bible says how that Peter now, right, a snake bit his hand, a viper, and he just shook it, and they said, this is not an ordinary human being. Imagine if all Moses had to bring the people out of Egypt was a desire to stop seeing people suffering. You know, he would have died right there in the palace. That's what a lot of people are carrying. They have zeal. Lord, I want to save my family with zeal. Zeal without knowledge will end you in disaster, because you will enter territories where you do not understand the codes of operation, and your zeal will frustrate you. It will make it look like Jesus did not die. There are many people who have sustained casualties. Some people went to their villages out of zeal, and they set altars on fire, they set shrines on fire. Before it finished burning, half of them was paralyzed from top to bottom, like the temple, the curtain that tore when Jesus died. Half of them from top to bottom, left hand side or right hand side. What do you know that sponsors your audacity to confront evil? What secret have you found? Those of us in ministry, what have you found that assures you that ministry will last? He says, I found your word and I did eat them, and it was a joy and a rejoicing to my soul. What have you found? What have you found that gives you confidence in this wicked society that we live in? What have you found, brothers and sisters? In Luke chapter 4, reading from verse 15 downwards, the Bible says Jesus found. He found it where it was written about him, the prophecy of Isaiah. And he said, this day is this scripture fulfilled. What have you found that gives you a guarantee that you will be married? By now you know being beautiful is not enough. What have you found? What is your spiritual advantage? When all else fail, what do you stand on? Job is one man I have come to respect and love. When you study the book of Job, this was a man who had all kinds of catastrophe in his life. Do you know what it means for a man to be the richest man in the East? The East has always been associated with wealth, right? Wise men came from the East. Job was such a, he said, in the days of my youth, when the secrets of the Lord were upon my tabernacle, the young men saw me and bowed their heads. The old men saw me and they stood up. What kind of influence did Job command? And then all of a sudden, in one day, everyone say one day. Say it, one day. It was not one prophetic day, it was one literal day. They came to Job and said, Job, your children, they are all dead. Your cattle, your house, everything. And all that Job was left with was his wife and his health. when everything disappeared, Job checked around, what mystery do I know that can help me now? And Job said, he blessed the name of the Lord and said, naked I came and naked I will return. Blessed be the name of the Lord. How can a man speak like that? Do you not know that there must be something you know that makes you to give thanks like that? Your children, your cattle, everything. Job did not know that there is a possibility of knowing what can happen in the spirit. I hope you know that the meeting that happened in the spirit was an advantage that was given to us by the person who wrote that book. Those in the earth realm did not know that something transpired like that. Little did they know that the sons of God came and Satan was part of them. And he said, Satan, where are you coming from? That means Satan does not stay in one place. And that means Satan is not omnipresent. Are you seeing that now? And Satan said, from my voyage around this territory. And he said, while you went around to families and territories, did you come across a man called Job? Satan said, I know him. I've seen him. I've seen him. I destroyed other families, jeopardized other people. But when I came to Job, I saw a level of fortification that frustrated me. Come on now. This is a conversation happening in the heavenlies. Whereas Job was minding his business here in the earth realm. Imagine what is being said about you in the spirit. And you are here just walking around. Naive, and you become a victim of the result of meetings where you did not participate in. I refuse it. The Bible says they know not, neither do they understand. Men discuss things in the spirit, and humans in the earth realm receive the result of the meetings. And someone gets up in the morning and returns back with one leg. That is the result of a meeting that was carried out. You were not there, but you were the victim of it. Don't let anyone fool you. The whole world lieth in wickedness. Someone gets up in the morning, blesses the name of the Lord, dresses well, and you carry your file to the office, only to return in the evening with a sack letter. Can I tell you something? When you understand the mysteries of the kingdom, you will know that nothing just happens in the earth realm. Jesus gave us a picture. He said, let it be done in the earth as it is. That means the earth is always a reflection of something that happens already in the heavens. Are you getting what I'm saying? Are you learning something? My passion is to help you see from a spiritual lens, to give you a new vista, so that you do not join men. You don't call what they call conspiracy, conspiracy. You can step home on the strength of a higher spiritual advantage. And you know what law to engage. This is what makes you more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. That means if Job had cursed God, he would have activated a law that would have killed him. Are you getting that? Because his wife gave us a revelation. She knew that that law existed. She said, Job, I'm your wife, but I'm tired. Do you want to die fast? Curse God. This is another revelation on its own. I don't know how you read your Bible, but I have positioned myself to see light in everything in the world. I don't read my Bible to have sermons or to cram scriptures. They are life to me. There are certain things that have intrigued me about the book of Job. One of it is the ability, hear me, the ability to invoke God and then God comes down. How did Job do it? Did he use a magic formula? Is it not in your Bible? Job summoned God and the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords showed up. Right now, we use all kinds of instruments and waste time for days. We say, we are trying, let's call down the presence of God. Job, a man in his pain, said, Lord, I demand a meeting with you. Brothers and sisters, what you know can make you look like a god upon the surface of the earth. Who is God speaking to tonight? It's time to rise up. There is a new status. There is an enlargement in the spirit. God wants to give you capacity to reign experientially. Oh, I sense the presence of God, strong and mighty in this place. And Job refused. And then another meeting was held in heaven. And Satan said, I have an explanation as to why Job didn't curse you. Because he's still healthy. He said, every man can give thanks. It's not unusual. That means as I went around the earth, I saw those I afflicted, but I left their health and they still gave thanks. He said, touch his body. God said, really? All right, go ahead and touch his body. A man was minding his business and Ebola came out. Are you seeing that? Those boils, hold on. Those boils, where did they come from? They were direct. It was based on an instruction. Like a text message you send and it will go to the person you sent it to. Job just found out that boils and blisters were coming out of his body. And his wife said, this is it. I've tried for you. After all, we've had plenty of children. So if it's faithfulness, I have proven that I'm faithful. It's time to go curse God and die. She wasn't sick. She did not know that it was not because she was standing strong. But she was not part of the meeting. The discussion was not about her. There are so many people who have not received any attack from darkness. They think it's because their spiritual life is strong. The day your file is open, you will see how weak you are. They laugh at others. Hold on. I'm very serious tonight. They are lazy. They don't pray. They don't fast. They say, I'm not praying. I'm not fasting. I'm not doing anything. But the devil would dare not touch me. Hold on. In the book of Job, there was a discussion. Nothing happened to the wife of Job. She didn't become barren. She was standing close to a man with a disease that could contact her, but nothing happened. Hallelujah. Are you getting blessed tonight? And then, when Job's body was sore, dogs came to lick his body. The Bible tells us that there were certain people that came from different territories of greatness. And they sat down for 7 days. They were using the wisdom that made them great to analyze what law would have been violated to make God judge a man like that. And for 7 days, they were brainstorming. After 7 days, they looked and said, Kai, Job, you sinned. We have checked everything. You sinned. Job said, don't talk like that about me. God will curse you. Better keep, if you don't know what to say, and Elihu reserved himself. Elihu was still checking. He said, the law of creation, the mystery of longevity, what law did Job break? This way, other people were just moving around. Job, sorry. But others said, no, let's check these laws. See, brothers and sisters, there is light that makes you different. Other people looked at the heavens and said, why is today bright? The wise men say, no way. Something is happening in the earth realm. Something is happening somewhere. And they started tracing it. Other people were saying, please, so let's dry the clothes very fast, whereas salvation had come. In Herod's palace, the spirit of the Antichrist communicated quickly. He said, another king has been born. Herod, do something about it. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Brothers and sisters, there are mysteries. When Jezebel, I told you that Jezebel is a system, isn't it? That's the she goddess, the system, the Antichrist system. Jezebel was married to Ahab. The spirit came into her. Why? Because Ahab represented governance. And she knew it was a mountain that held relevance. So she occupied there and she was practically the one ruling. Are you getting my point? And Jezebel swore when she heard that they destroyed the prophets of Baal. She said, Elijah, I must remove your head. Elijah went up to heaven. Now the spirit of Elijah came in John the Baptist. Jezebel re-entered Herodias again. Are you seeing? And that head of John the Baptist, she's got it. That was why when the birthday dance, she said, no, there is a score. He knows. There is such ignorance in the earth, man. We walk around. It's not our fault. It's the fault of all of the pastors, apostles, prophets, all of us that claim that we are men of God, because we are stewards, the Bible tells us, of the mysteries of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 4. Open my eyes, oh God. Open my eyes. 1 Corinthians chapter 4. When God calls you, can you have it amplified? Is it possible? Please, if you are in ministry, don't be in a hurry to rush or go on air. Are you getting my point now? Many of us are in a hurry. I want to go for a radio program and say what? Make sure you have something to say. It says, so then, let us apostles be looked upon as ministering servants of Christ. And what? Trustees of the mysteries, the secret purposes of God. That means when God calls you, your call tilts you in a position in the spirit where you have an advantage of access to the mysteries of the kingdom. And if God blesses you with a congregation and you are wasting their time telling them a lot of junk and jargons, the Bible says you are not a steward of the mysteries. And I refuse to allow you to be ignorant. You will be empowered with light. So when men are running, like the nation of Israel, away from Goliath, you will run to Goliath like David. David knew something bigger than a little stone. David knew something. He understood something. There is something you must know that can make you bold. That a man will look at you and say, do you know I can sack you from this work? You don't just do this foolish Pentecostal laugh. We laugh and they still sack you. You are laughing without revelation. We do stupid things in the body of Christ. Ah, God forbid you will not sack me. The next day, you are collecting the letter and you are going out. And you come and meet the pastor that taught you whatever he taught you. And he says, what happened? You mean they sacked you? It's an embarrassment to redemption. Well, it has happened. But Elijah was a man of like passion like us. The Bible says, and he prayed earnestly that there may not be rain. How can one man, didn't consult with the geographers, didn't consult with anybody, did not even use a public address system. He just said, on the strength of what I know, I understand that this territory has been given unto me as an ambassador, and I speak higher. Days will come when men will speak. We will speak when we have something to say, not just to make noise. Men will come. Look, let me tell you something. Times will come when the church will determine the events in Africa and determine the events across this nation. It's not to get money from politicians. Because you see, the Shunammite woman was a very wealthy woman. And when the prophet came, he said, what should I do to you? He said, should I talk to the governor? That means Elisha was not a small man. He could summon the governor. Say, you know what happened for you to sit down there? Are you ready to listen, or you are ready to follow those who are disobedient just like you? Having the readiness to judge all disobedience when our own obedience is complete. Hallelujah. One of our workers was sharing with me this afternoon a very touching testimony. He went on IT. He's still on IT. Brothers and sisters, as an IT student, first and foremost, there were two places that were paying him some very interesting amounts. When he told me, I was very surprised. That's the first miracle. Second miracle is that when he went there, the owner of the company where he was doing his IT said he wanted his son to be be the manager of the place, and since the son is not available, he should come and be managing the place. You want a job. The question is, what do you know? How do men get jobs? What have you been taught that brings a job? Application, submit your CV, wait. Is that true? Could it be that what you know is not the truth? That a thing has existed for a long time does not mean it is the truth. Listen, we need to begin to probe the foundation, the things that make up our ideologies. Start asking questions. Don't just absorb anything like that. Start asking questions. Why must that growth disappear and appear? It is in your body, but it is not within your control. Is violating a law. Already, it tells you that is demonic. How can some, because everything in your body should grow at the same rate. Now, this growth is not growing at the same rate. So, which life is sponsoring it? You did biology. Something else must be sponsoring that supernatural growth. It took you 20 years to look the way you are. It takes 3 days for a boil to come out like that. But when you are not interested in probing it, and it does not cause you to go to the secret place and say, Lord, what meaneth these things? I'm tired of allowing things to just pass. Hallelujah. Are you receiving something? I refuse to live my life based on guesswork. It's a terrible way to live. Brothers and sisters, I have a question for you. What is the guarantee that you are going to celebrate Christmas this year? Look at me. What is the guarantee? Is there a spiritual principle that can give you some kind of assurance? Or do we just walk and whatever will be, will be? I know this is challenging and I don't mean to hurt anyone, maybe of the demise of your loved ones, but I'm encouraging you. What is the guarantee that you're not going to celebrate? See, let me tell you. Many of us have not confronted these issues. We've forgotten about it and we've run away. When you run away from a thing, you have not defeated it. When you stand and face it and triumph over it. Hallelujah. Man of God, what gives you assurance that your ministry will keep growing from glory to glory? See, people have been saying they like me. Hey, people, you better find an authentic revelation. Because one moment they said crucify him. I mean, they said he gave us bread. We will force him to be king. The next moment they said crucify him. Can my life be so in order? When you pray for the sick, what gives you guarantee that they will be healed? Your pastor told you, lay hands on the sick, they will be healed. You saw him lay hands and they were healed. You say, me too, I will do it. Is that it? Or hands were laid on me and they say, you will now have the healing anointing. Is that it? I'm probing our convictions. And you will find out that many of us are not standing on the rock. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. What happens to you when they suddenly look at you? And listen, some of us come from territories where witchcraft is very open. What happens when you go maybe to your village or somewhere, for God's sake, please listen to me, and somebody looks at you and says, Pastor Femi, you will not get married. This is an agreement we have had. What do you do? And I say, I'll show them. Mm-mm. Let's not be childish this night. What will you do? What revelation? What key will be ignited? If I meet you now, Jimmy, and I say, you are 10 koinonia, you say, yes, I even had you sing. And I say, sorry, I've been going to a native doctor all my life. Please, here's the charm he gave me. Help me and break it. Take. What are you going to tell him? Book for counseling? Don't just laugh. I hope you get what I'm telling you. We are the light of the world. We are a city that is set on a hill. Break, help me, destroy this charm. I'm tired of it. And you hear that the last person who really held it died. That's when everybody says, you know, the way this word is, wisdom is profitable to direct. All these kinds of scriptures that emerge out of fear. All right, look up. What gives you confidence? That they are not plotting an evil plot to kill you this night. Is it impossible? I'm not making you afraid. I'm teaching you how to be victorious. Many of us think by running away from this, say, don't think about these things. I refuse to think about. I know that the Bible says, set your mind on things above. But Jesus, is it not your Bible where death, he said, oh death, I'm talking to you. Where is your sting? Oh grave, where is your victory? If you cannot confront, eternal life is not life after death. Eternal life is authority and victory over death. There are many things we cannot confront in the body of Christ. As I'm talking now, some of you are saying, please, so allow me get home safely first before you say all of this. What revelation did Jesus have that made him sleep when the boat was physically almost capsizing? How do you know whether your roommate has Ebola or not? Is it not till doctors say the person has it? How do you know? How do you know? Maybe since last year you have been passing those who had it. Look at this. A madman eats from the trash can. They teach us that it is not healthy. Abi, answer me. Is it not true? You spend how many years studying that reality? They taught if you eat, there are all kinds of microorganisms. A madman comes to sit down, turns the dustbin upside down, and he helps himself all through that night and gets up, cleans his body, and moves. While cold, you are in your room, you are lying down, and the cold, you have to add jacket and blanket. The madman is talking to himself and just strolling on barefoot. Rain is just beating him, and he's looking up and laughing. And you're saying, oh boy, this poor man. And the man is laughing back at you. Correct? And after 3 months, that guy is still healthy and strong. They say that there's crisis everywhere. They are running, the guy is moving around and talking nonsense. And the crisis will finish, the guy is still moving around. Question, who is really mad? This guy, because there is no hope of getting sick. There's no hope of even treating him. You will see him injure himself. He will leave the wound there. Flies disturbing it, he will leave it there. The wound will heal by itself. No, nothing. Could it be that there is something we have learned that has given the devil advantage over us? Could it be that there is something we have been taught that if we did not know it, we would not be this fearful? Technology has increased our fear because it has opened us to the possibilities that exist in this realm. You watch a movie and all of a sudden you just realize that cabbage can kill. You never knew. You ate cabbage, you stole it, you went to people's farm, you looted their products, nothing happened. Now you watch the movie where cabbage kills somebody and you said, this is it. This is it. Hear me, don't just laugh. I'm probing our convictions. It's time to ask questions. Not to be a rebel, but to ask questions. Everybody marries at 35. I mean, too, I grew up and I saw it like that. I won't you ask questions? I say, no problem, I'm 22. People served in church, they married at 37. You have not asked questions why they still serve and that happened. Could it be that your generation or your lineage is crying for a savior and saying, Lord, will you not raise somebody? And God says, you come for koinonia. There is something you must know that will equip you. You need to stamp it at the devil somewhere. Oh, the beauty of light. All of a sudden, you step home and you tell them, I brought good news. You see why the gospel is called good news? What have we been giving people? Bad news. All sorts of bad news. That means what we are preaching is not the gospel. Hallelujah. And you step home and you look at a lady who has not been married and you tell her, I'm not only going to pray for you, I will tell you what is wrong. It's not about you are a prophet. It's spiritual intelligence has made you prophetic. Hallelujah. Knowledge opens up the prophetic dimension in everyone. And so you look and you say, sister, there are certain truths you need to know. And when you know, you will walk out of this. And you begin to share those truths. And as you share, you will see the power of God. Last week, I think there was a gentleman that they brought. They had been, the one I announced, they had been on my case with that guy. I heard the guy was on a bike, minding his business. I don't know which corner he entered. One demon just fell on his head. The guy started speaking nonsense at once. No negotiation. It's amazing how the devil does not consult with us to try to afflict us. And this gentleman, the family members were confused and all of that. And I said, come for koinonia. And after the meeting, I didn't even know because I kept announcing, you know, we're about going, and they brought the guy. I said, sit down there. When I saw him, I said, my friend, you are going to be delivered now. I was not asking him a question. I was not trying to say, do you have faith? Is your faith working? What size? Is it weak faith or strong faith? All I know is that that demon is leaving. Period. Period. When you truly have money to give somebody and he asks you for money, you will say, can your hand stretch well or small? Are you ready to take? Take. When you start giving excuses and say, hey, I'm expecting, you know, there's one, it's my uncle, the way this Nigeria is. All those long stories are trying to point to one thing. There's no money in your pocket. It's as simple as that. This is how it is spiritually. When we begin to give a lot of excuses and stories, it's a sign that we have not held on to something solid. Oh, that God will make you a savior. This is what this is all about. Brothers and sisters, that God will make you a savior. Forget about the challenges today. Are you getting my point? Don't feel bad. Forget about it. But you tell yourself, I have paid this price once and for all. I said something last week and let me say it again. There has been this new discovery that has been stopping a lot of weddings, right? SS and AS. Are you aware of that? Lover boy, are you aware? Are you aware that this can jeopardize your destiny? That is not just enough to be in love. Are you aware of the implications, the questions you will be asked? I was told a very pathetic story of one guy who honestly had been seeing a sister. This guy had prayed. He was so convicted. He was so happy. And they went out on their first date. He was so happy. And then the lady told him, I think whether I'm SS or something, and said, this is the reality. And the guy said, whether he was AS or this. You see, it's a little issue. But now I have your attention. Because there are many of us that are probably asking this question. Is this how my life will be? But there is a way out. If you don't believe there is a way out, we don't deserve to call God God. There is a way out. Oh, there is a way out. We're tired of the status quo. There's gotta be more than this. We're tired of the status quo. There's gotta be more than this. There's gotta be more, gotta be more. There's The scripture I just read says that we have been called into the fellowship of these mysteries. That means the scrolls have been unlocked. Access has been given to us. Go and find out what it takes to reign. Listen, revelation is not knowing what God has said. Revelation is making it, knowing how to make it work in your life. That's revelation. It's not just what God has said. It's knowing how to make it work in your life. Knowing how to make it work in your life. Imagine that with the revelation you have now, after this meeting, you will run to a clinic where you know that somebody that you have been praying and trusting God for, who has been praying and say, well, this is God that brought this thing, and you just tell him, no, I've discovered something new. And I have come to prove it to you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, arise from this hospital. And all of a sudden, Joshua Selman was not there. Your HOD was not there. But the God you serve was there. And you will watch that person get up. And your name is brother, so, 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 and so. And all of a sudden, you go back. See, there is a joy when the word works for you. Not that it is made to work for you. When you provoke it, and you come with a testimony, you know that the word of God is alive. When you pray for someone and the person says, do you know, I didn't even tell you the gravity of what I was suffering. It's like, look at the gentleman who was speaking. This is a growth. A growth is not something you lie about. For those of you who don't believe in miracles, how do you fake a growth? You can fake, like many of you think we men of God around do, you can fake that, okay, genotype changed. But do you fake a baby? How do you fake that a woman was barren and now is holding a baby? How do you fake that somebody could not walk and is now standing? There are mysteries. Everyone said there are mysteries. And I'm planting a hunger in every one of us to begin to explore the mysteries of the kingdom. Oh, there are mysteries. When it was time to judge the prophets of Baal, Elijah said, let us go to a mountain. He said, no. There is a mystery we must invoke. Let's go to a mountain. And Baal said, I know what you are going. I know where you are going. I will meet you there. Other people were saying, why are they going? The ignorant ones always remain in the valley. Those who have knowledge climb the mountain. When they got there, he said, this is how we'll do it. You invoke Baal and I'll give you enough time. Brothers and sisters, they started calling on Baal. The Bible says they started cutting themselves. What did they understand about sacrifice and the presence of a God? They were cutting themselves to produce blood. They wanted blood to come out because they knew that blood is a language, is a magnet in the spirit. They look at how they were walking a lot of spiritual laws, and Elijah was laughing. He said, I know what you are trying to do. I'm sure Baal is sleeping. If you were the one, will you be laughing or you'll be praying? I said, Lord, let this thing not happen the same way it's happening. Don't disgrace me here. On the strength of spiritual knowledge, a man was laughing at the devil. When it was time, he said, there is a protocol to spiritual things. We don't do things foolishly. Let me have 12 altars. The Spirit of God said, a man of intelligence. Somebody would have just said, let me now show you. Oh God. And we do all kinds of things. And the devil said, this is it. He said, let me have 12 altars. And when there were 12 altars, he set up everything. He said, so that you don't think that we manufactured fire, pour water. The foolish people were pouring water. They did not know that there is a mystery of the spirit, the water, and the blood. The Bible says when it comes to the earth, these three entities can open any door. It says there are three that bear witness in heaven. The spirit, the word, and what? The Father, the Spirit, and the Word. But it says when it comes to the earth, there are three elements. Their coexistence will open any door. It says the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And Elijah said, pour water. They were foolishly pouring water. When they finished, he said, oh God. And see the fire that came. The Bible says the fire came and licked up everything. Elijah said, chase them. Kill every single one of them. When he killed them, Jezebel had it. What law was operated? What law? Who is this guy? And suddenly she realized that Elijah was not a normal human being. And Elijah said, I'm done. I came to judge this she goddess called Jezebel, because her prophets prospered and the prophets of God were in hiding. But one man was bold. Although there were many prophets, they couldn't come out. They were hiding. Elijah was taking fresh air. They came to disrupt him. He said, fire. Next, fire. The third people said, we are begging you. It's not like we are forcing you. We are begging you. We left our wives at home. We are begging you. Everybody say mysteries. Say mysteries. The occultic realm and witchcraft manipulate people through mysteries. Are you getting my point now? They use spells. They use enchantments. They don't need to see you. They make pronouncements. And when they make those pronouncements, when it comes, if there is darkness in you, it will prevail. Because they are called rulers of darkness. That means their dominion is activated when there is darkness. They are called rulers of darkness. But when they come and they see light, see, all this, I am uncursable, I am unkillable. You better understand the mysteries of the kingdom that activates those realities in your life. Because although you have been claiming and jumping, look at your life. It's already happening. I'm not scaring you. I'm telling you that there is more than what we have been taught. And brothers and sisters, if you do not open your eyes to see, you may not reign in life. There are many churches. There are many pastors struggling. I want crowd. I want this. I want that. And they do not know that there are mysteries in the kingdom. The Bible says, listen. It says, if I be lifted up. Have you read that scripture? MOG, let me give you a little clue. If I be lifted up, when a man of God keeps lifting himself, get ready for empty pews. It says, if I be lifted up, I will what? Draw all men unto myself, not unto a man of God. If I be lifted up, I will draw all men. When you keep drawing men to yourself, you will find out that there is very little you can give them. But when you draw men, when you reflect Christ, you stand as an ambassador, God himself. The Bible says, and God added daily to them as many as should be saved. Paul can plant, Apollos can water, but increase is exclusively of God. Hallelujah.
Tell me, what can I do? I can't live without you. I can't live without you. Tell me, what can I do? I can't live without you.
Listen, do you know that your family is under bondage? Because there is a mystery that has not been unlocked. Listen. There are mysteries are like spiritual codes of operations. I've shared it again during our series on mysteries of the kingdom. But I'll say it. Mysteries are like codes of operation. Look at me. If you have a drug, right? Just give me a viral cup or anything that I can use. If this is a drug, please look at me. Pharmacist. I'm not a pharmacist, so forgive me. Whether what I'm saying is right or wrong, let's just accept it. Are you getting my point now? In the making of this drug, certain things have been programmed. This drug is like a machine. Is that true? You don't look at it and say Panadol.
don't by any means go to my leg. I'm okay there. The trouble is by this side of my head. Better find a way of positioning yourself and solve what is there. No, no. You pick it up, carry water, close your eyes, throw it in your mouth and take water. You smile. You go back. The Panadol has been programmed to look for what is wrong. Because even you don't know what is wrong. You only know what you feel is wrong. Is that true? So when you go to a doctor, he looks at you and says, doctor, I don't know what is, my eyes. He says, it's not eyes. He says, I'm the one going through it. I'm telling you. He says, it's not your eyes. Just keep quiet. Take this, take that. And after 2 days, you come and say, doctor, I started giving myself medication for the past 1 week. The eyes, the pain has even increased. Say, who asked you? It was not eye problem. It's the symptom of something else. Listen, mysteries are like spiritual programmings. When they come into your territory, it's like an atomic bomb. They open up and they begin, those codes start writing themselves upon your family. So there could be mysteries that invoke barrenness. Listen to me. There could be mysteries that invoke academic failure. There could be mysteries that invoke late marriage. These mysteries ascend through whatever spiritual means. Dreams, enchantments. It says, in 6 things shall he deliver you. Yes, 7 things. It says, you shall be delivered from the scourging tongues of men. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? So this code lands like an alien and it begins to type out in your family that which it was programmed to do. Because mysteries work like the word of God. It's a mimicking. I told you that Satan was called what? Lucifer, the light bearer. He was the one who kept the revelations of the spirit. No word returns to the sender until it accomplishes what it was returned. If for any reason it returns to the sender, a higher word sent it away. Are you getting what I'm saying? So it says, so shall my word be that proceeded forth from my mouth. It shall not return. Hallelujah. It's like an SS1 student who tells a junior student, go and fetch water. And an SS3 student says, go and sleep. Who will he obey? If the SS1 student says, I sent you, say, no, please. My school father said I should go and sleep. I'm going to have my siesta. The SS1 student is now, he has joined 2 of them. Is that true? The integrity of the SS3 student and the SS1 student is what will be. And you say, I will punish you in front of this one to let you know I'm your senior. Or you kneel down. You go and fetch the water and give the junior student and he will use. That's a way of humiliating him to establish his seniority. Hallelujah. Mysteries. Everyone say mysteries. There are many well-meaning Christians, hear me, who are victims of the unlocking of mysteries. Someone comes and matches a charm. Brothers and sisters, this person is returning maybe from church with your Bible, from choir practice. You didn't see anything on the ground that shows that there is a charm, but you stepped on it. The charm has been programmed. He said, anybody's leg that steps on you is the person who said. And you step on it without light. And all of a sudden, you are minding your business and you see another law walking in your members. What is going on? Suddenly your leg, you can't tell again. The last time I checked, my leg was fine. What is going on? You get up the next day times 2, the size. Next day times 3. And they go to the hospital and they say, Kai, there's nothing. Doctors now already know. They are tired of the devil. Thank God for what God is doing in hospitals. Many doctors now, when they look at your case, they say, look, I'm advising you. If you know a man of God that is anointed, find him quickly. Because where you are lying down here, 3 people came, same condition. Thank God for doctors that are spirit-filled. Hallelujah. There are families like that. Brothers and sisters, I'm not the kind of person that sees demons in everything. There are principles. We're intelligent people. But I will deceive you if I tell you evil is not real. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I would have jeopardized the integrity of my calling. This is why many of us go through all kinds of cycles of a lot of things. Brothers and sisters, hear me. When you find yourself in trouble, if you find yourself in a hole, you can't bring yourself out. It says, they that sat in darkness have seen a great light. That was the light that came to them. And then he said, arise and shine for your light. Not because you can sit down there forever. But he says, when your light comes, then you will arise. Tonight, someone's, how many minutes do we have? I'll minister for a few more minutes and then I'll take time and we'll minister to the sick. Is that all right? I know that there are people who are trusting God for healings. I'm not the kind of man of God that'll say, now, after hearing this message, I hope that as you go back home, do something about it. No. Something must be done now. I'm not teaching you to start insulting people and just laugh and say, this man is not powerful, because we are all laboring to enter that resting reality. Listen, the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, hear me please, the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ gives us access. Our operating these kingdom principles bring us, it is us taking advantage. Hear me, when you walk in these principles, you are not trying to do something else outside of what Christ has done. It is your partnership with him. You're taking advantage of the access to make it real in your life. Are you getting my point now? Because that's where I understand that there can be confusion. A lot of us have believed that, okay, Jesus have done it. I believe it and I've said so. But I'm not seeing anything in my life. Deuteronomy 28 verse 1, it says, if thou it shall come to pass in that day, thou shalt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord to do and observe all that I command thee this day, that this blessing shall come upon you and shall overtake you. Listen, the Bible tells us again and again that we do not yet see all things under his feet. Please get this. Our walking the word of God is not trying to add to what Christ has done. Our walking the word of God is our response of obedience. Are you getting my point now? It is our proof of faith to make alive that truth. There are laws in the kingdom that were there before the fall of man. I hope you know. Job, I want to conserve time, but let me show you something interesting. Let's go to the book of Job. Hallelujah. 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 Job 38, behold, I show you a mystery. This that I'm about to read happened way, hear me, it happened way before Genesis 1. Job 38, okay. Job, through whatever spiritual mystery, I really do not know, but he invoked the presence of God. Then the Lord answered Job out of what? A whirlwind. You see that it was the same whirlwind with the chariots of fire that came and carried Elijah. And said, verse 2, who is this that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge? Who is this that is talking? Job, you are making a lot of noise. I've been listening to you from heaven. You've been saying so many things. You are ranting. Job, I want to speak to you now. Verse 3. Gird up your loins like a man. For I will demand of thee. I want to talk to you using my knowledge as God, and I want you to answer me if you think you have knowledge of that much mystery. Verse 4. Where was thou when I laid the what? That's question one. So God tells us the earth has foundation. Geography tells us it's revolving in space. God said, there is a spiritual mystery. A day, this earth is like a building. What kind of eyes will you see that will turn a God shape into a building? Declare if thou hast understanding. Verse 5. Who laid the measures? That means there was an architect. It was an intentional thing. The earth was measured. It has dimensions. Or who had stretched the line, like the plumb line you use upon it. Verse 6. Whereupon are the foundations fastened, like a tent? Or who laid the cornerstone? Verse 7. This God is telling Job that were you there when the morning stars sang together, the day the earth foundation was laid, there was a thanksgiving and foundation laying ceremony way before your arrival. This is what happened in the heavens. The morning stars sang together and all the what? I've said it again and again. Sons of God is not a New Testament concept. It has been there since. Sons of God is not a name, it's an office. Who shut the sea with doors? Brothers and sisters, that means the seas you see, they have spiritual doors. So when we see flooding, we know that a law was activated that opened those doors in the spirit. This is what God is telling us. Hallelujah. There's no such thing as just flooding anyhow. There are people by acts of divination, they have inquired in the archives of spiritual things. When it break forth, as if it issued out of the womb. Verse 9. When I made the cloud a garment and thick darkness a swaddling band for it. Verse 10. And break up for my decreed place and set bars and doors. God made a decree and said, cease, make sure you remain here. And said, hitherto shalt thou come, but no further. And here shall thy proud waves be stayed. Let's stop there. I just wanted to show you, when did this happen? And what, when this thing happened, Job kept quiet. Job said, wow. Wow. You see why the people worship God? Because heaven is a place of perpetual revelation. God surrounds himself with mysteries. So the mystery you saw before you bow down, when you stand up, is not what you will see again. It's like these lights. The way these lights change, that's how the mysteries around God, they are so many, they keep changing. And so in the book of Ezekiel, we see men saying holy. In Revelation, they are still saying holy. They've not stopped. They are saying holy. It's not that that's their work. They pay them salary for it. No, it is a response. They are not even aware that long a time had come and gone. Brothers and sisters, hear me. There are mysteries in this kingdom. Say it, there are mysteries. In many parts of this nation, every time they kill men, the people in those territories become richer. What do they know about blood and money? A man of God wrote a powerful book, Blood Money. Let me tell you the truth. Every money is blood money. Every. Whether blood of Jesus or blood of whatever, every money is blood money. Are you learning something? I'm not just teaching you this so that you will have theological knowledge and say, wow, I have something. But it is to sponsor your hunger for spiritual things. So that when men look at you and say, Pastor Femi, you are already healing the sick. What are you looking for? You say, what am I looking for? Paul said that I may know him. When Paul, at the apex of his ministry, saw that there was so little he knew, he said that I may know him. that I may know him. In 5 minutes, I'll show you something that the fasting tonight has done for you, because it's a mystery. Fasting is a mystery in the spirit that has not been taught because of the effect it has. We have not been taught that it is part of our spiritual growth process. I want to see you. Isaiah 58. I want to hear your voice. I want to know
more.
I want to know you more. Isaiah 58. I want to know you more. Silabakura to Shilabariadana. I want to know you. I want to know.
Verse 6.
Isaiah 58, verse 6. Is not this the fast that I have chosen? That means not every fast carries weight in the spirit. There are some fastings that are religiosities that have no power backing them and is just dead religion. Are you getting what I'm saying? But he says there is a kind of fast that God has chosen. Is this not the kind of fast that I have chosen? He said to lose the what? To lose the bands of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, and to do what? To let the oppressed, the word let here is to permit them, that they will go free, and that you break what? To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain, to break every chain. Break every chain,
break every chain,
to break every chain,
break every chain,
break every chain,
break every chain.
So it is in this kind of fast that you lose the bands of wickedness. In your fasting, you activate a law that strengthens your faith, kills unbelief. I truly believe that fasting primarily addresses one major issue, and that's unbelief. It opens you up, your organs of interaction with the spirit. All of a sudden, all the possibilities in God are the possibilities in you. There is a relationship between food, your body, and this realm. That's why gluttony is a sin. Gluttony is not fornication. So why is it a sin? Lust for food. The same way a man has lust for a woman. Someone has lust, but his own eye is not a woman, it's for food. Even if he has eaten, he can hold the bread and lie down and sleep like that. That is gluttony. That's the kind of case that requires deliverance. Fast. Hallelujah. Because, see, excessive food does something to your spirit man. It's like a meter. There is a level to which your eating becomes healthy. It keeps your body. Afterwards, it's like the law of diminishing returns. It's like you are inverting your spirit. Are you seeing that now? Because you see, your spiritual growth is inversely proportional to your flesh. Two of them cannot grow at the same time. Huh? So, when one is growing, the other one must bow. And part of that is achieved in fasting. When you fast and you pray and you declare the word with understanding and spiritual intelligence, you edify yourself, you activate certain things. To lose the bands. That means wickedness has a rope. Hello? It has a rope. tying down families. Many of us are victims of the bands of wickedness, like the hands of Samson, a great warrior but tied down, and nothing could be done about it. He said to undo what? Heavy burdens. A luggage that you inherited. They gave birth to you in the middle of a spiritual discussion that has nothing to do with you. And like Simon of Cyrene, you just received a luggage on your head you cannot explain. It says, to let the oppressed go free. Listen, there are different kinds of captivity, but there are certain people the Bible calls them lawful captives. Captives who are in captivity legally. It says, even the lawful captives shall be delivered. I will contend with them that contend with you. I don't know if you need peace in your life, but it's not just going to come by crossing your legs. You must engage spiritual keys. It says, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom, and whatsoever you bind, whatsoever you cast. Keys of access. Verse 8. Let's read together. Then shall what? So fasting is a mystery that accelerates revelation. He said, then shall your light break forth. There is something God has been trying to reveal to you. There is a spiritual understanding that steps up your stand in the spirit, but it's been limited. The weight of food and the weight of laziness, this inertia that comes with this body. And when you fast, you ease yourself. The Bible says your light breaks forth. As the morning, and your health shall spring forth speedily, and your righteousness shall go before you, and then the glory of the Lord shall be your what? Reward. It shall be your reward. You will see greater glory upon your life. Greater glory physically, in ministry, in life. You begin that. See, that's why some people go from strength to strength. When you think they have exhausted everything, they come up with a new dimension. Let me show you one last mystery. What's the time now? Isaiah 40. Let's just look at that finally.
We hunger and thirst for you in a dry and weary land. All we want is you.
Verse 28, please, let's hurry up. Isaiah 40 from verse 28. I want to teach you a very powerful principle. For those of you who have not listened to the teaching, Secrets of Sustained Glory, please get it. There's nothing as painful as looking at a man and say he once was powerful. He once was anointed. This guy used to have a flourishing ministry. God was alive in his midst. No, it should not be that. May you never have the testimony of Ichabod in your life, that the glory has departed. No. Hast thou not known? When God begins to probe a man like this, then he wants to reveal something he has not known. Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, he does what? Number one, he does not have this characteristic in himself. That means he does not have the ability to faint. There is a mystery encapsulated in his person that cannot permit this deficiency. It says, neither is he weary. There's nothing called tiredness. Because it is hope deferred that makes the heart weary. His word is yea and amen. There is no postponing, so he does not know weariness. It says, and there is no searching of his understanding. So he gives us certain things. Number one, mankind can faint. The word faint is to be fatigued, to be tired. We can be weary when what you hope for does not come, when the marriage does not come as when you want it. Are you hearing me? When the admission or the graduation, it is natural. Hear me. It is not a spiritual deficiency, as it were. It's part of the predicament that comes with wearing this body. But there is a technology in the spirit, and this is what I want to teach you. It says, he giveth what? That means there is a supply in the spirit that can bring power to you when you faint. And to those who have no might, he can increase like a meter. He can increase strength. Hallelujah. Next verse. Even what? I hope you know the Bible says the glory of the young people is their strength. So when the strong ones grow weary, it's a sign that we are limited. The youth shall faint. That means in your Christian experience, listen to me, no matter how anointed you are, no matter how blessed you are, a time can come in your life on the strength of the physical happenings in your life. This possibility can be true of you, that you can faint. Hallelujah. You trusted God for a great CGPA. You saw 5 points in your dream. When you went to check it, you saw 1.7. Say, Lord, what is this again? I've already packaged my Thanksgiving offering. I thought it was 5 points. Who is confusing me here? And then you may be a man of God, but at this time it will touch you. Are you hearing me? When you hear that your loved one that you have been praying for finally died, the Bible says, even the youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall utterly fall. That's why you hear certain people just sit down and you hear them talk, and you are like, sister, are you not born again? Say, see, if God doesn't help me, wallahi, whoever comes, I don't care who, I will shall marry and we'll flog it out when we get married. It's not like the person is not a Christian. This is what is happening. Are you getting my point? Don't criticize people when you see them fainting. And Jesus wept. He wept because he took this body and it grieved him. Jesus was hungry and he was staggering, and when he came to a fig tree, he wanted to pluck it and there was no food, and he was angry. He cursed the fig tree, because when you wear this body, you can faint. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Physical fatigue, emotional fatigue, when your hope is postponed. You are trusting God for the job and someone said, you'll hear from me maybe in 2 weeks time. And you've waited for 9 years, no job. Everybody keeps seeing you and say, you should be a director now, Abi. And you're even embarrassed. Yes, I'm a director by faith. Please don't embarrass me here. Must you laugh at me? That's the kind of testimony that some of us have. But let me tell you something. This is the technology. Hiya. When you get to this state in the spirit, when it looks like you are about to go down, it says, but they, that means not everybody is interested, but they that wait upon the Lord. Affect my life, breathe on me. I look to you for life. Affect my life, breathe on me. I look to you for life. Affect my life, breathe on me. I look to you for life. Affect my life, breathe on me.
I look to you for life.
If you're a man of God here, let me teach you a secret. Otherwise, one day you will sit before your congregation and start crying. I don't know how many messages I preach in a week. I travel all the time. I'm on the road. And there are all kinds of expectations. Every territory that invites me, they are happy. They listen to the messages. They go and invite people. And there is, you see, the anointing is as if you have holes in your body. Are you getting me? you become a conductor of the anointing and it tells on your body. That's why when you leave your body and you come back, you feel weak. Right? So, virtue, that concept of virtue going out is real. Many people have not felt it because they are not anointed. They feel the same way from the beginning of the service. They didn't bless anybody, nothing left. But when they touched Jesus, he felt something. He said, who touched me? Ah, it created an effect. Because there are times you are standing on stage and you will receive the pain of somebody. For that small moment, you will feel that pain and your body will respond. Where is this one coming from? The Holy Ghost say, no, no, no. This is a word of knowledge. But your body is still going to suffer that predicament. So by the time the service is done, a lot has left you. You've preached all of the messages. And then another message is coming and the people say, man of God, we saw in a vision you were doing great things. And you're saying, oh God. One day, you will just fall down and just die. Because you will preach every message. You will now check and say, now which one? Faith, they had it last year. See, those who are pastors are laughing because they know what happens every Saturday. Saturdays are the most stressful days for men of God. And they are meeting this because they are there sweating. They are wondering. You go to sermon.com, nothing. The heavens are closed. You go to all kinds of things. You try to listen to a man of God's message. You remember that, you shared that thing already and you are now wondering. I say, oh Lord. Don't let that become part of your life. There is a technology. They that wait. It's a system. It's a mystery. It didn't say they that shout and do stupid things around the presence of God. They that, what do you understand? A waiter, when you go to a very correct restaurant, what a waiter does is that he just stands waiting for your order. Right? They that come into his presence and say, Lord, if you don't help me, there is no help. And phone calls are ringing. Man of God, we are calling to remind you that God is going to use you. You keep those things and say, Lord, this is why I'm here. I'm here because of these phone calls. There's so much demand upon me. If you don't increase my capacity and help me. You know that song, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, fill me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up. The first thing that happens to those who wait upon the Lord is that they shall renew. It's like the charging of a battery. All of a sudden in his presence, God begins to, he fires one revelation that becomes your 3-month sermon. One revelation. Hi! It is my testimony. In his presence, all of a sudden, you think every message, you've exhausted everything. And then God gives you an encounter. And you start writing. And you are, sometimes I wish I can just organize Koinonia every day to just unlock that which is in my spirit. So your strength. Let's try that our song again. We will run and not be weary. I don't know all the stanzas. Da 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 da. Whatever it is. And his joy will be our strength. I will come into his presence. Many of you didn't go to Bible school. We will wait upon the Lord. In his presence is fullness of joy. And our strength shall be restored. As we some of you, when they were teaching that song in Sunday school, you were running and scratching people's car and stealing money and buying ice cream. When your colleagues were receiving, you were there. They drop you. Immediately they leave. You now run away. Hallelujah. So number one, they shall renew their strength. Physical strength. Spiritual strength. When you see a man 5 years in ministry, looking as if he has been in ministry for 50 years.
Well, you see, where everything is. I just write, whether he's there, I can't even remember. And what
laziness, inertia.
It says, they shall renew their strength.
Number two, they shall mount up.
Many of us, I don't want to go into the story of the eagle, but you know that there are times that the eagle needs to defeather itself, shed off the old for the new, because you cannot put new wine in an old wineskin. You cannot tie a new material with an old one. Their strength is not the same. Hallelujah. And so what happens is that in that place of retreat is the shedding off of that level. There is something that leaves you. The weaknesses. God wants to increase the ministry. He needs to increase your faith. He needs to increase your trust. He needs to increase integrity. Many things happen in that secret place. And then you will mount up. All of a sudden, you come up on stage and woo, there is a brand. When someone is listening to the message and is busy hitting his head, then he hears another dimension. This is an unending mystery. They shall run. Like Elijah. Elijah told Ahab, saddle your ass and run. Don't worry about me. There is a technology in the spirit that accelerates my life. Don't worry. You see, because when you are staying back in the secret place, it looks like you're a fool. Sometimes you will need to refuse a ministration that can honor you greatly. Is it not? You are about to go for a ministration where you know that the honorarium will make you happy. And God says, stay back. There's no true happiness outside of my presence. Stay back. And I say, Lord, the last time somebody smiled and wanted to give me a car, God said, remain there. But when you remain there, you will run. See, I'm teaching you a powerful secret. That's why when you look, you'll be wondering, is there anything to ENI there? Is there anything to Koinonia? Hold on. When we wait, we will run. Is it not a mystery in the spirit? When you want to run, wait. He said, when you wait, then truly you will run. Hurry, hurry in life. I want to hurry to do ministry. I want to hurry to be man of God. Bible says, wait. That's how you run. When you wait, then you will run. Jesus Christ was waiting and praying and interacting with the Father. They took the boat and they started going. 6 hours they were ahead of him, but they were not making any progress. That's how many people are doing ministry. They are doing ministry as if they call themselves. No proof, no sign, no witness. God doesn't confirm anything. They struggle to confirm everything. Ah, no, come on. There must be a supernatural dimension to your life. There must be a dimension men cannot explain. That's the proof that you are not alone. If you can explain everything about your ministry, you are doing it alone. There must be a supernatural dimension. They shall run and not be. So all of a sudden, Jesus Christ stands up and starts walking on the water. This is Jesus walking on the water. Strength came upon him. And the disciples, he was about passing them. He said, Master, Master, you can't pass us like this. You are seeing what we are going through. Jesus looked at them. They thought he was a ghost. And Peter said, I like this, your technology. So there is something like this, and you left us struggling with the boat when we can walk. Brothers and sisters, drop moving in the boat and wait so that you can receive the feet to run. Are you getting me? Many of us are so slow in our lives. We are trying to hurry up and we are leaving the presence of God. And we believe that by leaving the presence of God, you will hurry up in life. You are joking. That's why a man can start a ministry. After 12 years, the man is alone as if God didn't send him. And they say, anybody you see moving like that, forget it. Something must have been done. Is that true? Learn this. If you don't learn anything, if you want to run in the spirit, wait.
I want to hurry up and marry. Say, let's walk around. Is it not when they see us? Wait. Ah, you think we don't know what you people discuss? Look, let me tell you, it's good to let people see you, huh? But where was Ruth when God was fixing her destiny? Naomi was busy talking to her. She was waiting. When you find yourself running without a track record of waiting, one gentleman sent me a text and he said, man of God, I feel the call. How do I launch out? I replied him, I said, forget about launching out. Settle down. You see, that's the language. Launch out. In other words, how do I take this thing? The fire that is burning my spirit, nobody knows. The fire of God, if not understood, you can misinterpret that fire to mean that it's a sign to run, whereas it's a sign to refine you. And not be weary. He said, and they shall walk. And the Bible tells us in Isaiah 43 that when you are walking, it means there's fire around you. When you walk through the fire. So when you are walking through what is killing others, you are standing tall. And people are saying, what technologies? I waited until the fourth man arrived, so I'm not alone. Hallelujah. We are going to pray. Rise up on your feet.
Come live in me all my life. Take over. Come breathe in me and I will rise. On eagles.
Two prayer points very quickly. Two prayer points. Hallelujah. There's a family that got to contact me. I don't know if they are here. Is it a sick person or a mad person or someone like that? Are they around? Please protocol find out. If they are around, then we'll just start fast. If they're not around, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Two prayer points. Prayer point number one, Jeremiah 33 verse 3 says, call unto me and I will answer. It says, I will show you. I will not just tell you, I will show you. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 1 and 2 says, I will stand upon my watch, I will set myself upon the tower to see what the Lord will say. You're going to say, oh God, let the revelation of the mysteries of the kingdom. I'm tired of ignorance. I'm tired of living my life anyhow. Open up the scrolls of the spirit and grant me access to revelation. Lift your voice and pray. Inside and outside, we are praying now. Shake it, take it, ba 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 ba. Make a pratica la ba 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 ba. We are praying now. Leke te porakata baladabas. Mande ke prince ke la boko shotolo ba 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 ba. Shake it, ba la kosoto baladabas. It has been given unto you. Jesus Christ paid the price already. It has been given unto you. To know the mysteries, the spiritual codes that govern dominion. Pray for the sake of your family, for the sake of many that you have been anointed to save. There are destinies tied to your life. Don't let them die. There is a mystery that you will know that will stop these spells, these yokes of darkness from your life. Open our eyes, oh God. Open our eyes. Pray. Grant me light. I hate fear. I cause fear. Reveal something to me that takes fear out of my life. Reveal something to me that takes insecurity out of my life. Reveal something to me that stops competition in my life. Let me stand on a solid rock. Koinonia, pray. Zeketa baba 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 baba. Rakata pratekate. Zagata pondo kotolobodosh. Zagata brata katalekatebos. Sopros kete balaraba. Open our eyes to the mysteries of the kingdom. Open our eyes to the operations of spiritual laws. Hallelujah. 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 Prayer point number two. You're going to pray, whether you fasted or not. You're all in the corporate atmosphere. You're going to pray and say, Lord, every band of wickedness over my life, please hear me, over my family, over my loved ones, I stand tonight as an ambassador and I declare that enough is enough. Those bands be broken now. Lift your voice and pray. Shekete ba 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 ba. Come on, loose those bands over my family. I declare, I come with the rod of a higher priesthood. I confront witchcraft, the system of evil, the system of death. I challenge you as an ambassador. Thus far have you come, no further shall you go. Pray, pray. Your prayer will prevail. Your prayer will prevail. Shekete kababa. Makatate pokoto. We confront delay. We confront delay. We confront poverty. We confront late marriage. We confront barrenness. We confront terminal diseases. Confront witchcraft, spells, yokes, enchantments, divinations that are carried out in heavenly places. Manda katabosa, reketetebos, stargazing, necromancy. We challenge those powers. We challenge them. We come as ambassadors, sons of light. Sons of grace, sons of power. Shake it, ta ta ta. Go protoko to break the balance. Oh, we challenge them. We challenge them. We challenge covens. We challenge spells. We will not be silent. The King of Glory steps into our families. The King of Glory steps into your academics. Enough is enough. Pray like a priest. Pray like a priest. I tear down the curtains of wickedness. Tear down the bands of evil. Challenge the spirit of death. Challenge failure. Challenge delay.
Spirit. Pray for your ministry. Pray for your job. We tear down spiritual walls, limitations. Be broken. Yokes, be broken. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon us. Just give me 5 minutes and God is going to do something mighty in this place. The devil must let you go. Shake it. Oh, he must let you go. Victory is imminent. Your God is alive. A few minutes and we're done. Something must break open in your life tonight. Hallelujah. Listen. The Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee. Hallelujah. He must flee. Must flee. I tell you, our families must testify that Jesus is alive. And we are tearing down limitations. Lift your hands. There are families that have been limited in many ways. We are going to shout that name Jesus once. I saw this many times as I prayed today. As you shout that name, the sword from heaven will descend upon certain people. And there will be a tearing apart. I tell you, a tearing apart. I already sense the anointing of the Spirit. Lift your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, every family represented here, inside and outside, that have been facing any kind of limitation, I judge that power and I declare that as they shout this name, let it rattle the foundations of witchcraft and sorcery in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you ready now? Manteca parataba. 1, 2, my God, 3. Koprotoskepa. Seketete. I cost those altars. I cost those altars. I cost those altars. I cost those altars. Inside, outside. I cost them. I cost them. I set them on fire. Mekopotos. I come with an apostolic rod in the name of Jesus. I invoke the powers of heaven.
I release your family now. I release your family from witchcraft. I release you from delay. I release you from limitation. I release you.
Lift your hands again. Hallelujah. Now lift your hands. I see at least 12 families. Hear me. The Lord is bringing restoration. Hear me. Restoration. As I begin to speak, God will locate those families. Exact families. Right now, Lord, let your power those families for restoration in the name of Jesus. Let the angel of restoration move inside and outside. Let the angel of restoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Sevenfold. I declare it. Sevenfold. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord wants to break academic bondage. Lift your hands. This suffering is over. Lift your hands. Hear me. You're going to shout that name Jesus again. When you shout it, there are many of us. I'm seeing chains. This is how it will leave you in a shocking way. Are you ready now? Father, everyone here under any spell and bondage of academics, in the mighty name of Jesus, we bring that situation under judgment. 1, 2, 3. Go. Go. I judge that power. I judge that power. Mandega de bakata prondo kotoba la sita. Shakratika lebosha. Hallelujah. We'll soon be rounding up. I see a lot of packages that are supposed to have come upon many people. Listen to me. But I see them hanging in the spirit. So many. For many of us, you have seen it in visions. You know it has been released. Mantata. As I speak now, there is a release. It's coming on people. Right now. I open the heavens. Let it come. Let it come now. No matter how long it has stayed in the spirit, I command it. No matter how long, if I be a servant of God, I invoke it. Let it come now. If I be an apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, I invoke it. Let it come now.
I'm walking in power, walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am. I'm walking in power, walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am.
Everybody sing, say.
Oh, I know who I am. name of Jesus. Shout it. Say it again. In the name of Jesus. The days of ignorance are over in my life. Prophesy it. Say the days of ignorance. The days of lies. The days of deception are over in my life. Lift your voice and pray in 1 minute. Lord, I entertain your light. There is something you can know about you that will bring you into the anointing. There is something your mother told you growing up. You are a failure. But hear the truth. Hear the truth. There is something Africa is speaking to you. That we are a third world nation. But in the name of Jesus, I declare. Shabrakoto sodobakata. Ende karoto subrakata. I believe the truth. I believe the truth. No more lies in my life. Everything that is not consistent with the word of God, I refuse to believe it. Why we look not at the things that are seen, but the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are temporal, subject to change. Hallelujah. Please sit down. So they may look at you and say, sister, you are getting to 40, no husband. Will you ever marry? That's their information. You see, when you introduce Jesus to the situation, the calculation changes. Something that should be zero, just because you introduce the reality, everything changes. The psalmist said, I had fainted, but God. I had fainted. I knew that I was over. But God, when they brought him into the situation, it changed everything. Stop listening to lies. There are lies on TV. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There are lies that we hear on newspapers. Oh, stop tithing. All those men of God are out to collect your money. It's with your money they use to buy clothes, and they rob you, and you listen to a lie and stay back and authorize Satan to destroy you. Our society is full of lies. People make money through lies. Jesus, the truth. There were many things. I didn't see many successful people in my life growing up. Those who were successful were very far from me. Culturally speaking, societally speaking, there was a mindset that was communicated. But when I began to search the word, goodness, I found another report. A report I was not born with. And all of a sudden, Jesus said, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me. You know, today we took a stroll, myself and the head of protocol. After we went to greet a bereaved family, we went somewhere and I was taking them inside the campus, and I decided to take a tour of the new structures they are building. And while I started passing some sites around the dam and down, my eyes were almost, I was trying to fight tears. Do you know why? Because I saw locations where years ago I sat down to study the truth. I passed one place, a botanical garden on your way to the dam. I used to enter that corner and smuggle myself through somewhere and sit down. Broke, but had access to the truth. A failure and a mediocre, but had access to the truth. And this Bible, God gave me an assurance with the word. If you believe me, I will not play games with you. And I was stupid enough to believe. I said, Lord, after all, by default, I don't even have much. So if I don't believe you, I don't have any option. Ah! Look what he's made in my life. Listen, if you choose to believe the truth, he will change you. They've lied to you that your life is not doing well just because there is something you are not, you know, you need to go and connect to this, you need to do that. I believe in favor, but favor is only when it comes from God through men, not from men. If you don't give 150,000 to so person in federal ministry of this, you will never get a job. That's how we do it. You are not part of the we. And you find out, and the Bible says that when a man's ways pleases the Lord, that's the truth, that he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. Are we together? Listen, the part of scripture you find and believe is the part that works for you. You can see two people operating on different dimensions of realities is the part you find. I have found from this word, listen, and I don't want you to be offended by what I'm saying, but I've found from this word that it is possible for a man to fulfill his days. I found it. I used to fear death. I think it's one of the things we all fear. Because the teaching I got about death was that any day it can meet you anytime. And it looked like a very sincere talk until I searched. I said, God, but how can I live my entire life being afraid? I'm going to live a life traveling all the time. Right? I'm in the air, I'm on road. In the morning, in the afternoon, there are armed robbers, weather conditions. What is the guarantee that I'm going? I mean, I can't live my life. I'm going for a crusade somewhere and I'm afraid. I want to go and heal the sick, cast out demons. But me, the man of God that God will use, you are now afraid whether you arrive safely. As soon as you arrive, your heart returns back and you're like, hey, thank you, Jesus. What a torturous way of living. But there is a truth. There is something you can hold and dear death, you look at it in the face and say, oh death, where is thy sting? Now you see, until you have caught that truth, don't make mouth. This is the problem. We talk nonsense in church and say all kinds of things and become victims. It is the encounter of the burning bush that qualifies you to stand before Pharaoh. When you have seen the burning bush, you can stand before Pharaoh and say, hey Pharaoh, stop oppressing God's people. Because Pharaoh will not let you go just because you can speak English. Jesus, the truth. Let me tell you something. Life will dare you to your face. It will take the truth to build a world of fortification. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I believe the word of God. That's why we're gathered here tonight. This is called a miracle service. There is no guarantee anywhere that anybody will be healed. There is no guarantee anywhere that devils will be casted out. Let me tell you, without understanding the truth, any action you take is arrogance. You make a fool out of yourself. What is the guarantee that in the next few minutes, the Lord is going to step in and begin to produce miracles in the lives of people? It's the truth. As at morning, when they were fixing this place, what was the guarantee that people were going to come and all the seats will be filled? What was the guarantee that people will be following us from over 45 nations of the world? Is the truth. There is an information you know. The power of God. That I believe you, oh God, and I'm ready to follow. You will not lie to me. I believe you. You are not a man that you should lie. Not the son of man. I don't doubt him. I believe you. My experiences notwithstanding, I still believe you. Number three, Jesus, the life. A revelation of his power and his ability to make alive. Jesus, the life. John 11 verse 25 to 26. An event happened there, Lazarus was a man who had died 3 days. And then Jesus said, he sleepeth. And they were going to go and resurrect him. And when they went, they saw his sisters crying. Now, this was talking about physical death, but it applies to every area. Watch this. Death does not just mean cessation of breathing. It means cessation of life. Many of us are experiencing death in different areas of our lives. When an organ fails, that's death. Are we together? The sons of the prophet were eating a meal and they looked and said, ah, there is death in this food. And Jesus said to her, I am what? What is resurrection? Bringing back to life something that is not supposed to have life again. Hallelujah. That for me is the definition of hope. 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 Bringing back to life a dream that should not come alive again. Bringing back to life a destiny that should not come alive. I live my life drinking and smoking. Is there hope for me? Jesus is called the resurrection. I should have done well with my life, but I'm 70 years now. How many more years do I have? When the resurrection comes, he can bring back to life. Are we together? I should have been a PhD holder now, but so and so happened to me. When the resurrection comes, listen to me. Jesus has the power to make things that are dead in our lives come alive. This is good news. Are we together? So the Bible says, rejoice not over me, my enemies. You know my fall, but you have forgotten that there is a mystery of resurrection. Rejoice not over me. Yes, I know for now I do not have a job. I lost my job. Yes, I know that this and that may have happened in my life. But there is Jesus, the life. He can put life back. He can put life back. Let me show you something the Bible says. Very interesting. Well, let's finish it. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, although his kidney were dead, he can come alive. He that believeth on me, although his finances were dead, he can come alive. Do you know that hopelessness is one of the major causes of depression in our society? You know what hopelessness is? A perception that there is no press to anything that is worth producing any result again, and people just give up. Society is full of angry people who just walk around and say, look, there's no hope. No hope for this child. No hope for this. No hope for me again. No, I'm already past menopause. No child. Let me just agree that I will never have a child in my life. Listen to what the Bible says. Job chapter 14, please give it to us, 7-9. Job chapter 14. Shalabakuriata kasubrendiakata. Read it with me, please. One to read. For there is hope for a tree. For there is hope for Joshua Selman. For there is hope for any life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? For there is hope in spite of that medical report. Humanly speaking, you should put your house in order. Ask Hezekiah. When a true prophet came and said, Hezekiah, I've heard from God. When a man hears from God, who else do you consult? But Hezekiah said, no way. I know this mystery. There is resurrection. There is life. There is hope. He turned his face and said, God, let's talk. I know Isaiah is your prophet, but I'm your child too. Let's talk. Remember now. Come on, God. Don't act as if you ignore me like that. And God said, yes. Compelled a dimension. Listen, let me tell you, tonight you have to insist for some things to come back to life. Some of you don't even pray over some things again, because in your mind you have concluded it's over. That business will never come alive. We just give glory to God, it's over, it has gone. That destiny will never come alive. But it's okay, I already know that I would never walk again. My leg can't walk, so my focus now is to just succeed. I am the resurrection and the life. It says, for there is hope for a tree, if it be what? Cut down. I like that word. Cut down, not rooted out. Cut down means the root is still connected. The mistake the enemy made was to still leave you loving God. I know you lost joy, you lost peace, you made a mistake. I know you now have a baby. It should not be. But the mistake was that you were cut down, not rooted out. And the Bible says that it will what? Sprout again. Talk to me, agriculturists. That you know that you can cut a tree and children can even put satellite dish on the tree, yet it still starts growing. Have you seen a tree that they use for pole wire? It doesn't stop the tree from growing.
I hear the joy coming. Hey,
I hear the breakthrough coming. I hear the sound coming.
Sound of abundance and joy.
I see the lifting coming. Yeah.
Hold on. Listen. I tell you, the anointing of God is strong upon me. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Give us that scripture again. Give us that scripture. Because God wants to make a statement with this miracle service tonight. He says, for there is hope. Everybody say, there is hope. Let the devil hear you. Let all the people who have sat down together in a meeting and say, will she ever rise with this carryover, with 11 carryovers, will you ever rise? The Bible says, there is hope for a tree. There is hope for a tree. It says that it will sprout again and that the tender branch will not cease. We're reading to verse 9. Though the root thereof be waxed old in the earth and the stalk thereof die in the ground, verse 9, yet kabaratos kebranda katashiata. Hold on, it didn't say through the arrival of water, the scent, proximity to life, proximity to life. The moment you come into a place where there is life, it has not touched you yet, your roots resonating with life. Listen, listen, those of you who have done physics, there's something they call resonance. Is that true? That when you use a tuning fork and hit at a frequency, every other object within that frequency answers to it. You were designed by the life-giving spirit. So when Satan tries to bring death, and then you are seated somewhere and you come into an environment where there's life, deep starts calling on to deep. Your dream starts telling you, I'm ready to come back to life. Forget the fact that I failed. Rejoice not over me, my enemy. We live in a society who are experts at burying people before they die. Ah, look at this mama, 9 children, all useless, and she's coming for koinonia, and they say, keep going mama, tonight the resurrection and the life. The resurrection and the life. Hear me. How about a man of God? You know God called you, you know he anointed you, but truly you have not seen increase, not in your life. Oh God, where will the anointing come? Or maybe you were once anointed and something happened in your life and things went down. And listen, it is true that Jesus died, but did he die forever? He died only for 3 days. While he had resurrected, men were still talking about his death. Could it be, hold on, could it be that some of you, while you are in this meeting now, other people are talking about your past life? They don't know resurrection is happening. They are still sitting discussing yesterday. So every time they look at her, they say, I know this lady. Oh, this lady is the most nonsense lady in our environment. You were right, but ask Rahab. Shabbatos kotabriata. Listen, do you know why God instructed that they killed everybody in Jericho? He did not want anyone who knew Rahab's past to be part of those who follow her, because she would be part of the lineage of Jesus. Listen, when God wants to make nonsense of Satan, he will keep quiet and allow men finish tearing you down. Sometimes you can even join them and tear yourself. And then when he's done, he says, let me now show you the expertise. Let me show you what makes me God. And he starts building. Many people conclude on men because they don't know God. This God we serve. Are we together? I always use promises. Promise, come, 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 come. With all my heart, you would have concluded this guy was a capon in black acts. Are we together? Years ago, with dreadlocks, he came to Zaria with dreadlocks and earrings. He was an occultist of the highest order, a territorial commander. He ran away because they were about to imprison him. But brothers and sisters, rejoice not over me, my enemy. No, 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 help them under the anointing, please.
you would have concluded that this brother will never become a, because our big mouth in society, we are experts at talking about people. But while they were talking about Saul, God was seeing Paul. Apostle, but I don't even know who my father is. I'm not sure. They told me that fair woman is my mother. That's the kind of background I came from. Don't worry. The God of Israel is an expert. Look at his life now. A fiery man of God with grace and power and anointing. Hallelujah. They had concluded on Zacchaeus. You are a thief, you are a fraudster, you are an armed robber. And when God was going, he had to climb the tree. And God said, come down, Zacchaeus, it's your house I'm going. Let me show you that I'm going to your house. And at once, Zacchaeus said, I will repay everybody. And Zacchaeus completely changed. Hear me? I came to preach to someone tonight. There is a dimension of Jesus called Jesus the life. The life. The life. Jesus the life. Jesus the life. Jesus the life. Jesus the life. That everything that has died in a man's life can come alive. Even time can come alive. That's the God that we serve. Hear me? You have come tonight, some of us from far, some of us from several things, and you have come to encounter Jesus, the life, the life-giving spirit. He can put life back to your finances, and the money you lost 10 years combined in 1 month can return to you. Listen, please, let's not make this thing look as if we're acting. We're talking about God here. Apostle, but this is 10 years, no child, and they told me that there are all kinds of cysts and growth in my stomach. And then when the resurrection comes, he all of a sudden, first child, triplets. Second child, twins. You say, God, stop. He says, stop what? My name again? Third child, 1, 3, 2, 1. Registers his name. The years that the canker worm has eaten. Hear me. Mordecai did something that was good. And his testimony was archived in a book and dropped quietly. You see, ba? There is a day God gets angry and vows by his name. I have seen this, truly speaking, that God vows a vow. Read it through scripture, that he wants to lift a man. When God vows a vow to lift a man, I tell you, not even your personal faith will stop you. There is such a thing that God can say, the appointed time is come. I've seen people lifted overnight. And frankly speaking, sometimes they've not even understood certain principles. God just vowed with his name. Tonight, I want your faith to be, please, look, listen, you have come before God. This is not a cinema to watch film. You have come with your heart open. I want you to insist tonight. All these three dimensions are dimensions that for a taking. But I perceive that one of the greatest dimensions we need is life. There is too much death. There is too much death in people's life. Dead organs. Hold on. Listen. There are people here. They can't walk 10 minutes. A young man, 25, 35. You walk 10 minutes, you breathe as if you would die. They go to the hospital and say, Mr. Man, almost everything we see is wrong. You need life, oh. You need life. There are many ladies here with all kinds of lumps, all kinds of demonic things. Satan attempting to put another life, because there are many kinds of life. But when his life comes, there are destinies, you look at them like walking corpses. You know everything is dead. No favor, no open doors. There are many men here, you are hardworking, but there is no life. You are just a body walking, sweating, toiling, the cause of hardship from morning till night, living from hand to mouth. The key is not promotion, the key is life. Life.
To draw from you again. To drink from you again. To drink from you again. We've come to the rock.
Walking out the same tonight. I insist. Lift your voice and pray. Lord, I can't go back the way I came. I place a demand. A demand on your anointing. A demand on your anointing. Prayer point number two. Change my level, oh God. Hey. Change the dimensions. Take me to another level.
Please keep standing, everyone. The Lord is going to move tonight in a unique way. Please let me have your attention. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There's a lot to do tonight. We're going to do it in this order. I'm going to take the altar call now. And then tonight we're going to start with the sick. I just sense a very strong manifestation of the healing anointing. Hallelujah. Now, quickly, let me have your attention. My God, the power of God is so strong, so strong. I already see activities of angels. You're in this place, inside, outside, any of the overflows. 1, 2, 3, 4 by the roadside. I told you that the cure for the challenges of men is an encounter with Jesus. And there are people here. Some of you may be visiting for the first time.
But you know that you need Jesus genuinely, not just as a religious philosophy. You truly need Jesus Christ. Some of you at one point you handed your life over to him, but things went haywire, and right now you know that you need to run like there's fire on the mountain. Overflow one, overflow two. I'm going to count one to five. Please clear the way for them. I want you to run as though you are thirsty and they told you where water is. Leave your seat right now and run, whether you are inside or outside. I'll count one to five. Keep standing. One. Koinonia, celebrate them. Two. Are you running? Run to Jesus. Lord, I'm tired of my life. Tired of the way things have been. I can't pretend it. I'm running to you now. Three. Celebrate them. Are you running? Leave your seat, break your pride and run. I need Jesus in my life. I need Jesus in my life. This is a matter of urgency. This is no pretense. This is no church. I need Jesus in my life. Have you decided to follow Jesus? No turning back. Run! No turning back. Have you decided to follow Jesus? No turning back. No turning back.
One more time.
I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back.
I'm seeing three people in overflow three. There, and the Holy Spirit is telling me they are supposed to be part of these people. Overflow three. Please, quickly. There's so much to do. There are three people I'm seeing in overflow three outside, and the Lord is telling me they should be there. Don't allow your friends stop you. I'm still going to give one more minute. One more minute. As the Holy Spirit is convicting you, you're saying, I want to come, but I'm a bit shy. Run, make your way quickly. Come and join us. Come and join us. Hallelujah. Look at me. Please let them come and join. Those of you in front, please look at me. I salute you. This is serious business here. Please, there's nothing to be ashamed of. Hold on. Hold on. Now, you see, when most people give their lives to Christ, they come in emotionally. And some are not even serious. They come laughing, pinching themselves, Lord Jesus, and they are laughing and not serious. This Jesus business is life. We are not talking about a certificate. We are not talking about a husband or wife. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Please hear me. As you are here, make sure that your decision is genuine. No one condemns you, but I want you to mean it. Please don't play games with God. This is the God of heaven. I want you to say this from the depth of your heart. All of you in front here and those joining quickly. If you are joining them, make your way to the front. Say this passionately and truly. Say, Lord Jesus. Say it again, Lord Jesus. Some of you are not saying it. Say it one more time, Lord Jesus. I believe in you. That you are the Son of God. I believe that you died for me. I believe that you shed your blood for my sin. I believe that you resurrected for me. This night, I have heard your word, and I declare that I need you in my life. I hand over my life to you. From now and forever,
I receive eternal life into my spirit. I declare that from today, I am a child of God. Satan, you heard my confession. Stay away from my life forever. In the name of Jesus. Let me pray for you now. Jesus, we present to you the ones you died for. When you hung upon that cross, you saw them, and they were worth your blood, your tears, and your death. I ask, oh God, by the power of your spirit, that you preserve them. Let this not be an emotional decision. I pray sincerely that today will become the beginning of a new season of your grace, your power, your mercy upon their lives. I declare your sins forgiven. I decree and declare that from today, you walk in newness of life. I set you free from everything that holds you down. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. I congratulate all of you for making this most noble decision. Never forget this day. Never forget this day. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, I will ask you to do something very quickly, and then you come back and join the service. I want you to follow who is waving his hands. Follow that gentleman waving his hands, and they will lead you out. And there are a number of people who will welcome you. Have your details. Please cooperate with them. And all the people attending to them, let's make it fast so that they can return back. Please politely follow them. They'll ask for your details. Cooperate with them. Everyone this way. Let's honor them as they go very quickly. Hallelujah. Can we help them? Let's make it fast. Now, we're going to do it this way. I'm going to start praying for the sick right away. We're going to pray for the sick now so that we can take out time. Let's deal with the sick first. I already sense a very strong manifestation of the healing anointing. Lady, look at me. The Lord is asking me to stretch my hands. I command that devil. Let her go now. You heard her confession. I curse you by the God of heaven. I released you now. I'm seeing this lady tied, snakes from her leg to her head. I set you free. This is Koinonia, the place of encounter. I decree and declare that from today, you are set free. And there's something I'm seeing in your stomach. I decree and declare that it leaves you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, we're going to pray. There are certain cases I want to deal with by myself tonight. Any case, please listen. Any case, whether you are in any of the overflows, please, I will pray for people. Overflow one, I want you to march to your overflow. Those who are trusting God, you came here with for yourself or for your loved ones. But let's do it this way. All those who are trusting God for the fruit of the womb, if you have an issue with barrenness or a blood-related disease, HIV, cancer, or any deadly disease, whether you are in the overflow outside or what, please come in and I want to minister to you myself. Hallelujah. That doesn't mean, please listen, it doesn't mean if I'm not the one ministering to you, you will not be blessed. The anointing on me is upon everyone who will be standing to minister to you. Are we together now? So let's not have a rowdy crowd there. So overflow one, I like all of you who are trusting God to be prayed for. Please, I want you to move to your projector stands. Overflow 2, overflow 3. Those online, connect by faith. And we're going to be praying for you. Those inside, make your way very quickly. The special cases that I asked, make your way quickly, please. We have to be very fast. There's a lot to do. The reason why we take our time to minister to people like this is because God has anointed us for this reason. Hallelujah. God has anointed us. It's a privilege to carry his anointing, and we must take our time to release blessings to God's people. Make your way quickly. Look how many people need the touch of God. What a joy and a blessing to have the anointing and the ability to touch people. Can we all pray as a family whilst they are coming and ask the Lord to touch and heal and bless everyone? Lift your voice and pray. Everyone, lift your voice. Lift your voice, pray. It's a miracle service. Please, those that are coming in from outside, make sure it's only blood-related diseases. terminal diseases. Otherwise, you can just wait at your projector stand and then they'll pray for you. Father, you have anointed us in this place. You have anointed this house to be a tabernacle of miracles. Lord, you have produced untold testimonies. It's a privilege to be extensions of your hand again, ministering to the needs of your people. It is your desire that in every territory, there must be a place where men and women can find the power of God at work. And Lord, thank you for making this such a place. Tonight we pray that there will be abundance of your anointing in the name of Jesus. Tonight is serious business. I really perceive that there is need to minister to people. We're going to have some of our leaders stationed in various places. Please, I want you to trust the anointing upon them as they come to minister. I'm going to just make contact with them. There will at least be two at different points, and then we're going to pray. Praise the Lord. We'll make it very, very fast and trust God to minister to you. Please come, Pastor Femi, Ejimi, Pastor Alpha, West Benga, Promise. How many of you? I think we need 8 people. I have to lay hands on you because I sense that we need a great 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Michael, come. One of these days, we'll begin to train other people and help. The idea is to help and build people. Mike, leave the keyboard. Someone else can play the keyboard. You can come. This is an opportunity. We are going to lay hands and then we are going to trust God. Shade, will you be strong? Come. She's always had the healing anointing. You have the strength? Please come. This lady you see is a compendium of the healing power of God. And so we're going to pray. I think this is okay. We're going to pray. Please, those outside, if they don't ask you, if they are prophesying to you, it's a different thing. If they are giving you a word of knowledge, it's all right. Otherwise, you don't have to start talking and doing all of this. Lord, we agree right now in Jesus' name. My God, there's such anointing on my hands. As they lay hands on the people, Lord, I decree and declare, let your power flow in such dimension, in such magnitude, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the anointing of the Holy Spirit come upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power of the Holy Spirit, let the fire of God come upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that you will carry the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Shade and Promise will go to the overflow outside here by the road. Shade and Promise, Benga and Femi, this overflow. And then Mike and Pastor Alpha will be at the overflow 3 now. Ejimi will be with me here. Pastor Alpha. Okay, 2 of you are there. Okay, fine. Who is left? Michael. Okay, then join them outside this overflow here. And then we'll walk with Ejimi inside here. Praise the Lord. Lord, we decree and declare, let there be miracles right now. Let there be signs. Let there be wonders. In the name of Jesus, let there be such a strong move of the Spirit. Let the sick be healed. While this is happening, please, I want you, if you need to make calls and ask your loved ones to submit their prayer requests, let's do that very quickly. We're trying to conserve time as well as maximize the grace that is available. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you all the praise in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. So we'll pray for you now. I want you to trust God for miracles. Trust God for miracles. Insist that God must give you a miracle. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
As we worship in your presence, there is healing. The Holy Spirit, gentle touch, is flowing. Jesus,
in the name of Jesus Christ,
I believe. Jesus, there is healing in your name. As we worship in
Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Gentle touch. It's flowing.
It's flowing.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I believe.
I believe.
Jesus.
Jesus.
There is healing in your name.
There is healing in your name.
Holy Spirit.
I want you to believe that there is no power holding on to your destiny that will go back with you. Please believe this night. There are strange spirits that are responsible for the sufferings. You see this dear lady? This lady came all the way from Lagos. Had to resign her job to come here because she was tired of what was happening in her life. It's not just about employment. Came here. This lady came, I think it was last week, all the way. Because she was nothing at all. She was employed, but oppression after oppression. There's somebody in the congregation. I'm seeing like the Lord is opening my eyes. This is strange. And I don't know what it is that I'm seeing that has to do with elephants. I'm seeing an elephant. And I'm seeing like fire coming. This is a deliverance for someone in the congregation now as I'm talking. I'm praying for the sick, but we're going to minister to other needs. But right now, the Lord is asking me to minister to such a person. So I'm declaring right now that every manipulation of spirits that resonates with what the Lord showed me, right now from here, I decree and declare there is no peace for the wicked. I command judgment right now in the name of Jesus Christ on such a person, wherever you are. In this congregation, I decree and declare right now that the power of God touches you right where you are. Right where you are. Right where you are. In the name of Jesus. Right where you are. Right where you are. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing someone at the minister's stand. The minister's stand. I'm seeing something like an arrow shooting out of your body. Lord, in the name of Jesus, whoever that person is, it must go now. I decree and declare by the power of the Holy Spirit, every strange devil, every strange spirit, we decree and declare that this environment is completely not conducive in the name of Jesus. I want you to look at this. Look at what the devil can do. This is a human being's face. Mama, come. Madam, is this her mother? Mommy, come. How long has this been?
This is 1 year now. A year plus, yes.
Her face just started swelling.
It started bleeding from the nose. And before you know, this eyes shoot out.
I prayed for her the last time.
Yes.
You see it going down?
Yes, I see it going down.
You see it
down
from the last time? Yes. Who was there when you saw the last time?
It's going down.
You see it going down now? Yes. I prophesy that in the name of Jesus Christ, right now, that the way this thing has started going down, it must go down normally. And hear me, Mama, any human agent that is responsible for this thing happening, are we together? If I am a man of God, that person must die this night. Hallelujah. Because I'm looking at you, hold on. I'm looking at you and I'm seeing the face of a woman. And I'm seeing a woman sitting on ground like enchantment. I say it again. Whoever is responsible for attempting to terminate the destiny of this lady, by the God of heaven, may the ground open and swallow her now. Hallelujah. God bless you. See, let me tell you something, brothers and sisters. Wickedness is very, very real. Very real. Very, very real. Very, very real. I want you to lift your voice in 1 minute and say, Father, judgment tonight. Pray. Lift your voice. Shabakato soto bakata. Lembrekete katatatata. Reketo shepekeriata. Everything that must give way for the next level of my destiny to be open, I command it so. Now, by the power of the Holy Ghost, pray inside, pray outside, pray by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, pray. Shaka toko 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 kesh, rekete kete kata bara 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 bas, mata kato shepe kete, lente preketa basha bara 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 bara, leketa proskata baranda kapraskata bara tosh. Are you praying? Make sure you are praying. Let her go now. Out. 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 I see the rain of your love. I feel the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. I see the rain of your love. I feel the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. So let it rain. Really going to pray seriously right now. I've been seeing a lot of visions while praying for the sick. Hallelujah. There are many, many demons that must go. Many, not few, many. Oppressed, all kinds of strange demons. Bring this girl. Come. Bring her. I'm seeing a spirit. Bring her. Let her go now. Out.
Victory belongs to Jesus.
Listen, hear me. Now, we are going to pray serious. That's why I took out time to maximize the healing anointing, because we want to finish fast. We have leaders meeting. However, now that we have dropped this, please just focus. You have prayed now. Let me minister to you. Praise God. Stand up, please, everybody. We have to pray. These are the wicked spirits that are responsible for families. Families. Tonight, I see an uprooting. I tell you. Listen, I want you to stand, because I'm seeing people running out now by the spirit. Not like wanting to run away. The spirit running with them. That's why I'm saying, I'm asking the people to stand. We are going to pray. Please listen. I want you to believe. The forces that tie your life, tie your destiny, it's time for us to pray. It's time for us to agree. Are we together? I want you to cooperate with me and let's pray. They are strange spirits. You will bring them out. Some, don't be embarrassed. This has to do with families. This has to do with individuals. Are we together now? Are we together? Yes, we are going to pray. I'm seeing like a Ghana must go, and I'm seeing it tied in the spirit. Whose destiny is that, oh God? It's time to be loose now. Bring them out. Please, I need strings. Strings of the flowing sound, please. Bring them out. Sheketeketa. Brakatoso toba shata. At his word, every demon, every devil, there's no hiding place for any power of darkness. I decree and I declare in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Please hold your hands together. I want to pray a prayer. You are going to help your neighbor now. Something strange is going to happen to people. I want to pray, because I'm seeing like fire passing from people to people. This contact must be maximal. Lord, I pray, anyone who is a victim of any oppression, as this fire passes now, in the name of Jesus, once you see your neighbor manifesting, please let them come. In the name of Jesus, I release that fire right now, from row to row, from people to people, from row to row, inside, outside. I command every stranger, soketakatakata, every stranger, in the name of Jesus, every stranger, outside, overflow one, overflow two, overflow three, online, I curse that devil right now. That fire is burning. Every principality, every power. Shaka-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Outside, mighty deliverances. Outside, from road to road, the power of God is setting people free. It's time for yokes of captivity to give way. It's time for age-long captivities to give way. Paroto sosese siatata. Rakatos kabaria dabalakoto shubia. Hallelujah. Everyone say after me, in the name of Jesus. Just do what I'm telling you to do. Say in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of delay over my life, over my family, be judged now. Now watch what happens to you. I decree and declare, anyone with such yoke, I command judgment now. Judgment now, now, on those forces. Let them go now. Let them go now. Let them go now. Please lift your hands. Shabaratos Kotosh. Tonight I trust God for an extensive time of deliverance. Listen, the Lord is opening my eyes and I'm seeing snakes. This is what I'm seeing coming out from holes. Anyone here tied by any spirit, they come to you in the night to sleep with you. Fire at the count of three. One,
two, three, right now. Visitors of the night, strangers of men's destinies, I judge you by the God of heaven, inside and outside. I judge you by the God of heaven. Hallelujah. Please put your hands. Sisters, lift your hands. Sisters, lift your hands. Sisters, lift your hands. I want to pray a very serious prayer right now. Sisters, lift your hands. If there is anyone here having any spirit molest you in dreams, appearing as men, appearing as women, appearing as animals, at the count of three, as you shout Jesus, Jesus the life is destroying any dead. Are you ready? One, two, three. I command those devils, those strangers, powers of witchcraft, molesting people, the daughters of Zion, I curse you. I curse your covenant. Every high thing must come down. Every stronghold shall be broken. You wear a victor's crown. You overcome.
You overcome.
Say,
every high thing must come down. Every stronghold shall be broken.
You wear
a victor's crown. You overcome. Hey. You overcome.
Hallelujah. I saw what I'm seeing now in March miracle service. And the Lord is asking me to stretch my hands. I'm seeing padlocks. That's what I'm seeing. This is representing men's destinies. Nothing is happening in your life. You are not lazy, but doors have refused to open. Right now, at the count of three, I want everyone to shout Jesus as loud as you can. Some of you will literally be caught up in visions, and you will see the doors of your destinies open. Right now, oh God, I declare that every padlock over any man's destiny, over any man's life, at the count of three, they are open. One, two, three. Be open. Be open. Be open. Be open. Be open. Destiny, open up. Hallelujah. The Lord is asking me to take away the spirit of death over families. Listen, you may not even know, but I want you to believe. I want to pray for you. Death is a spirit. Death is a spirit. Death is a spirit. I'm speaking now. Death is a spirit. Oh, death, where is your sting? Right now, I'm seeing at least 47. I'm seeing the number 47. Every family with death hanging over them. Fire, 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 fire upon every family. Fire, fire. The spirit of death broken. Hallelujah. Can I pass through the crowd for a moment? I want God to do a quick work. Please listen. I don't do these things out of religion. It is the presence of God. The presence of God. I don't have time, and there's no opportunity to lay hands on anyone. But listen, I just come across your role. I just want you to believe. Listen, except it is not the spirit of God, but any other strange spirit aside from God, regardless of what it is,
and what is causing in your life, it must give way right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, just play me. Father, in the name of Jesus, listen, please, I want you to believe, this is not about human worship, but as I pass your room, I'm seeing fire on my left and right. Tonight is the ministry of fire, and like a wildfire, it will pass you and begin to consume things. Some of you, as I pass, that physical fire, that heat, Lord, let it be right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, rakoto shoprekete baratokosia, rakato totoketata, rakato shabariakata, take it here. That fire, fire, judging everything, judging every evil from every row, row to row, row to row, row to row. That fire right now, every witchcraft, every power, every witchcraft, every power, tying anyone, someone's womb is being loose now. Someone's womb is being loosed. Someone's womb is being loosed. In the name of Jesus Christ. Can I go out? Is it possible? Those outside, lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Hallelujah. Please quickly, we're out of time. We have to conserve time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now, all of you right here, through this place, I'm looking and I'm seeing change in the spirit. And as I pass this overflow, please, I want you to believe that every captivity must come to end. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? It must come to end. Father, I give you all the praise right now. Right now, a chain is leaving somebody here. A chain. Go now. Chains. I break it now. I break it in the name of Jesus. You don't have to touch me, just be. There's somebody here. The yoke of delay is breaking now. It's breaking now. By the power of the Holy Ghost, break it now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Break it now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing a cloud in this place. I release that fire. Break it now, right now, in the name of Jesus, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, help them, please hold them. Break. Hallelujah. I'm hearing a name. Is it Elisha? Elisha. 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 Who is that? Elisha. Where are you coming from?
Abiu.
Abiu here. I want to pray for you. The Lord wants to give you and your family breakthrough. Elisha, I wish we had time, but in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm declaring. What's your name?
My daddy's name is Elisha.
Your daddy's name is Elisha. That's all right, I'll pray for you. Why are you here? You are Elisha. Look at me. I want you to believe in the prayer I'm going to pray for you. God is going to give you strength in your peace.
Amen.
I'm seeing like a shrine on fire. Hold on. I'm seeing like a shrine on fire. And that fire in that shrine will manifest physically over somebody's life. It's time for this family to be set free. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. It's time to be set free. It's time to be set free. Elisha, I pray for you now. Hold my hands. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare, something is leaving you now. As I'm holding your hands, I'm seeing something leaving you. Let it go for you and your family. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Your dad needs breakthrough. I decree and declare, by the power of the Holy Spirit, the Lord brings that breakthrough right now. The Lord brings that breakthrough right now. Please, if we can get some of the people outside, make sure everyone is protected under the canopy. Otherwise, let's see how we can squeeze some of them inside. Even if it's just for the sake of when the rain minimizes, they can go out. Please, make sure nobody is standing in the rain. Those standing at the edges of the canopies, we can allow them to come in. Just come and squeeze them somewhere, please. Make sure, especially women with children, please. Please make sure that we allow them, please. They can come, just stand anywhere. The goal is us, please. Just give them room, just orderly. They can come in and stand anywhere. Recurrent issues. The Lord is addressing them now. Our time is gone, but I'm praying. Recurrent issues. The power of God is going to fall on people now. I don't know how those outside will do, but I pray for grace for them. But I'm seeing a grace to destroy recurrent issues. Issues that come, you solve them and they come back again. Where are those people? I stretch my hands right now. In the name of Jesus. That fire is visiting them now. Recurrent issues. The Lord is setting people free right now. Recurrent issues. Please help this woman. Recurrent issues. That devil is going right now. In the name of Jesus. Recurrent issues. Recurrent issues. Never again. In the name of Jesus. Never again. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Please, I know it's raining, but participate. God is touching people. I'm seeing it again. Recurrent issues. Issues that come and you think you are done with, and they return back. I decree and declare that fire is coming now. That fire is coming now. Recurrent issues in the name of Jesus. Be set free right now. Be set free right now. Be set free right now. Hallelujah. Towing. Towing. What's your name?
My son name is Towing.
Towing. I will pray for you. I'm seeing serious witchcraft in this lady's family. This is heavy satanic oppression. Heavy satanic oppression. All of you are toying. What's your name?
My auntie.
Who?
My auntie's name is Toying.
I will pray for you. Please make sure you are toying. Don't come out carelessly, but hold my hands. I will pray for you. I will use you as a point of contact to pray for your family. Hold my hands with both of your hands. Your family must be free from witchcraft. Lord Jesus, fire, fire on every altar, fire, on every altar of witchcraft, I command, I use her as a point of contact and pray for every family under the yoke of darkness, under the yoke of bondage. I command your emancipation now. I command your emancipation. Every family under the yoke of darkness, are you doing? You have bad luck. Bad luck on your life. Very bad luck. Hold my hands. Hold it with both of your hands. Lord Jesus, this is a miracle service. Set this lady free. This yoke of bad luck, I decree and declare that it must leave you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, it must leave you right now. Your sister, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you. The same way God is touching her, may God touch you too. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. My dear, you are doing.
My auntie.
Where is she?
Not yet.
What is this for?
This is my family. My mom left my dad some couple of years ago and became a mother. And her immediate younger sister too is also a mother.
Hold the photo. You believe that when I pray for you, God will touch them. Lord, visit this family right now. In the name of Jesus, I release the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, through you, let it touch your family. Please don't come out carelessly. Don't come out. Why is she out? Why are you out, my dear? Huh?
My sister is doing.
Okay, I will lay my hands on you. Be free. Your mother, something is leaving your mother. In the name of Jesus, I curse that spirit. In the name of Jesus. Kai, what is this? Look at, I'm seeing a snake. This is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing a snake. Please, just thank God it's raining. If you are inside, don't complain. Those outside are enduring the rain. Just keep quiet and allow God to visit you. Snakes. I saw a snake from this lady and I'm still seeing snakes around. There's no hiding place for darkness. Rakoto soto koto bakarata kotia. Shakata kata kata bata. Rakato soto prekete kata. I'm seeing snakes. Lord, let there be deliverances. Let there be deliverances. In the name of Jesus, inside and outside. Let there be deliverances. In the name of Jesus, let there be deliverances. Let there be deliverances by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Scriptures talk about a blessedness that happens to a man whose delight is in the law of God. So as someone says, it says, but his delight is in the law.
God is going to use you.
And don't
mightily lift your hands.
Day and
I'm
night.
Looking at you and I'm seeing it.
That man
the lady that
like
God
a
is going to use mightily. That doesn't mean after service you come and start discovering her. God is going to use you. Father, let that grace.
As you are about listening to this message, we believe that your life is going to be like that man planted by the rivers of water. Your leaves are forever going to bear, and we know that your season will not pass.
Don't worry, believer.
You will forever shine.
In the name of Jesus Christ, every access given to you by darkness, I close it now. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I close it now. Right now, in the name of Jesus. I close it right now by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I close it by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I release that fire and that power. There is no hiding for any darkness. Release every breakthrough. Release every destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hold on. I'm hearing Maymuna. 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 I don't know if he's here or outside or someone. Your love, Maymuna. Huh? is what? Your step. Okay. Memuna. No, I'm seeing something else. I will pray for you. Memuna. The Lord is showing me something else. Your name is Memuna.
My younger sister. My younger sister.
Okay. I lay my hands on you. Look at me. You are not progressing. Hold my hands. The Lord wants to move you forward. This is not even in the name of Jesus. I release you to move forward right now. I command that you move forward in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord gives you visitations by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Ah,
hold my hands. Hold my hands. Both of your hands. I lose you to prosper, and I lose your family to prosper. You came out to stand for someone, but you are the one God is giving the visitation. I decree and declare it by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I command right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. You won't believe what I'm about to pray for. I'm seeing written in the air, forgetfulness. There is a strange spirit that comes upon men and causes them to forget things. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, Shatatatakatosh, Brandakatos Kalabregedigia. If you are here, whether it is memory loss or strange forgetfulness, the things you should do, you forget them and you pay the price. Wherever you are, I release you from it right now. I release you from it right now. I release you right to the back, outside, all the overflows. Anyone who has that manifestation in their lives, I release them right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release them right now. I release them right now. I release them from it right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release them right now. Why is he here? Why are you here, sir?
My cousin.
Is what?
My cousin, we were here last week, but he didn't come today.
Your what?
My cousin, Tony.
Okay. In the name of Jesus Christ, may God touch them. Whatever their issues are, I declare that God will resolve it right now. In Jesus' name. I'm seeing somebody I need to pray for. Physical money disappears sometimes from your pocket, sometimes from your bag. I'm not talking of stealing. Listen to what I'm saying. Don't just come out carelessly. Money, you can hold money like this and count it and see that it is less. It has disappeared. Who is that? I need to pray for you. It's a very serious issue. Yeah, na 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 na. You?
Disappeared.
Hallelujah.
Kai,
the Lord is showing me something very serious. There's somebody, don't be embarrassed. You woke up physically in the middle of the night. And now I'm not saying you idolize animals, but there was a rat, a physical rat, not running around. You were looking at it. It was looking at you like this. There's someone like that here. Rat. It was looking at you. You were, wave your hands. Let me know you are the one I'm talking to. Come out. Come and stand here. I'm not saying if you have rats in your rooms, that's not what I'm, this is a special, unique, demonic case. Come. This lady, I have to pray for you. Favor, zero. Breakthrough, zero. Trouble, 100%. Father, in the name of Jesus, change this face I'm seeing. Jakatos koprakato zakatolia katabakanda prakisia. Lekos kapranda gada suze breketekatos. In the name of Jesus, zekata tata suzia. Mante bros kataprande katolia kata. Shakas kendekos. Akras kate zeketonsh kamatan zekata reketo sekete keteketa bakata mambrato soto bere keteria kata shase zezezekata mabroto soto topaka embriata sada siata shakel kata maskata bariakato embre keteketa keteketa rekos kososo pekete dekata mebriata size kotosho pariakata. Break the chains, break the chains, break the chains, break the chains in the name of Jesus.
Oh,
There is somebody, your grandmother appears to you. Your grandmother appears to you. Where is that person? Come. Don't be embarrassed. This is a serious issue. Our time is gone, but thank God it's raining. We are going to round up. Your grandmother, you see your grandmother. She appears. Who is that? Wave your hands. Come and stand here. It's a very demonic thing. Your grandmother appears to you. Come and stand. Grandmother appears to you. Who is that? Wave your hands. Let me know you are here. All of you that see your grandmother, come and stand here. We have to break you from that demonic thing. What fellowship has righteousness got to do with lawlessness? This Lagos lady, God is on your case because you need to be thoroughly, thoroughly delivered. There is a spirit that is oppressing you and there's no hiding place. You hallucinate. This lady literally sees things. She can be here physically. It's, you know what they call astral travel? She can leave, not vision, leave physically. This lady, I command that wicked spirit in the name of Jesus. And whatever she sees about you, except you are powerful, it must happen. It's a spirit. She doesn't even know why. In the name of Jesus, I'm looking at her and I'm seeing a cat. I curse you by the God of heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. Please don't be tired. I know our time is gone, but it's raining. Let's just visit these things because... Come. You are a beautiful girl, but no favor in your life. Shift. Let me talk to this yellow girl. Come, run. God wants to wipe your tears. Ah! I'm looking at you and I'm seeing something like a crown on your head. Come, you must be delivered thoroughly. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let this curse of disfavor... This is a beautiful girl, but there's no favor in her life. Shato soto bakata, randa koto soto kete barakata. I decree and declare every legal access of darkness. I curse it right now. I curse it right now. I open the doors. I open the doors from the realm of the spirit. Let there be favor over your life. In Jesus' name, hold on, sir. I need to pray for you. This encounters, supposed encounters, has retrogressed your life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I have to pray for you because you are not supposed to be at this level right now. You too. You see your grandmother. Where are you from? Calabar?
No. Obudu. Obudu. Cross River.
Obudu. Cross River. I have to pray for you. Please, if I didn't call, why are you here? You know why you are here? Huh? You see your grandmother. Kai, there's somebody here. Hold on. All of you see your grandmothers. Don't laugh. You see, let me tell you. This is not some, it's not mockery. It's not, I'm not saying every vision of grandmother is demonic. Please don't get me wrong. These are very special, strange, wicked and demonic issues. Strange, wicked, and demonic issues. Someone has fallen down there. Please let the doctors attend to the person. Make sure you are your brother's keeper so that they don't fall down and injure themselves. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Kai, you, come. What business do you have to do with dead people? Dead people. Eh? Hold my hands. Say in Jesus' name. Say it seriously. In Jesus' name. Every affiliation with the dead, I curse it now. I release an anointing upon you now. Everything you have to do with dead people, in Jesus' name. Do you love Jesus? You love Jesus? Huh? Mm-mm. You are not serious with Jesus. Hold my hands. How are you? Don't be embarrassed, but the first thing you need is your relationship. I'm looking at you. I don't want to embarrass you, but you need Jesus seriously. I love you, eh? That's why I'm helping you. I love you with all my heart. Go and meet the who? Where's Pastor Alpha? Just meet him. He will talk with you. You need counseling. Your own is not just grandmother. God just brought you out here to. Your destiny is needed. Please go and see. He'll talk to you. Now, all of you who are having these issues, I'm going to lay my hands on you now. When I lay my hands on you, I want you to believe. There is this strange Kai. I'm seeing someone appears to you in the night, and when he appears to you, please don't come out at random. As soon as he appears to you, your spirit literally starts leaving your body.
Literally, as in you feel yourself, you will come out and you will see you again lying down on the bed. There's somebody with that case, that situation right now. I have to pray for that person right now. I have to pray for that person right now. Something comes, pulls your spirit out like it's going. I will lay my hands on you. All of you are so many. Father, every affiliation with darkness, I'm going to lay my hands on all of you very fast. Sir, I'm looking at you and I'm seeing the spirit of poverty and lack. Serious poverty.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Nothing works.
Yes,
your
sir.
Life is like a basket. Everything that enters goes out. I'm not embarrassing you. Eh?
You are saying the truth.
Money leaves your hand. Even if they give you 1 million, it must find a way of going.
Yes, sir. You're a sincere man,
but money does not stay.
Yes, sir.
Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Do you tithe?
Yes, sir.
You are not consistent. One. Two. You see, this consistency of tithing is one way to drive the devourer. God is not a magician. You have to be consistent. Praise God. God blesses you 10 times. You tithe once, your heavens are completely closed. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lay my hands right now and I command breakthrough. In Jesus' name. Let me lay my hands quickly now. You're the God of miracles. Amazing God.
You're the God of miracles.
Go now and cast that spirit.
You're the God, you're the God of wonders.
Amazing,
amazing God. You're the God of
the Lord
miracles.
Wants to bring favor to your life. Strength, favor.
Amazing,
receive that favor.
God. You're the God
Jesus Christ.
Amazing.
For your patience, I just took advantage of the rain. I want to prophesy over your life now. We're going to be very fast, 5 minutes, and we're out of this place. Please, I want you to believe every prayer that is coming now. Every prayer, come. Every prayer, the Lord is taking you to a new dimension in the name of Jesus Christ. A new dimension, a new level. Cameraman. God is wiping your tears. Keep the camera first. Wiping your tears. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is wiping your tears. The In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord is wiping your tears. This lady, I'm praying God is visiting her family. That lady standing close to Ella, I'm seeing a vision that the Lord is going to show her a breakthrough. I'm commanding right now in the name of Jesus, everything tying down your families, particularly the Lord is asking me to release family now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Now I decree and declare by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, I prophesy. Those outside, please follow me. Those online, follow me. Our time is gone, but let's just be patient. 2-3 minutes, we're out of here. I decree and declare from tonight, move forward in the name of Jesus. Move forward in the name of Jesus. Move forward in the name of Jesus. Make progress 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 in the name of Jesus. Advance in the name of Jesus. Advance in the name of Jesus. Be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Multiply in the name of Jesus. Anyone here who has lost anything in your life, I declare, I'm seeing 28 in 28 days. Shato soto koto pakata. 28 days from now, I command that it comes back to your hands. I command that it comes back to your hand. I command that it comes back to your hand. Anyone here who has been victimized by life, by circumstances, by men, I decree and declare, may the God I serve vindicate you right now. Everyone here in need of direction, you are praying, oh God, I need to know what step do I take. In the name of Jesus tonight, strange encounters that bring you direction. Strange encounters that bring you direction. The yoke of poverty and hardship and lack, I command it to live your life now. I command it to live your life now. Live your family now. Live your destiny now. I pray for every family represented here. Whatever you are trusting God for as a family, I release my faith with you and I decree and declare that it is turned into your testimony now. The kind of favor you have not seen from January till now, I decree and declare from tonight, not tomorrow, from tonight, let it start working in your life. Strange favor in your life. Strange favor in your life. God has placed his honor upon this ministry. I pray for you from today, anywhere you go, whether they know you or not, I command them to honor you. Believe it, I command honor upon your life in the name of Jesus. Two more prayer points and we're done. Whatever has made your pace of your life slow, some of you are moving forward but you are too slow for your destiny. At the rate you are going, you will not do much in your lifetime. I prophesy to you in the name of Jesus, receive the grace for speed. Receive the grace for speed. Do in 1 month what you have not done in 5 years. In the name of Jesus Christ. And finally, I pray for you. Whatever has taken advantage of your spiritual life, your prayer life, your fasting life, word life, passion for God, passion for the house of God, right now I stretch my hands and I declare fresh fire on your altar. Prayer fire on your altar. Word fire on your altar. Fasting fire on your altar. I decree and declare upon everyone, receive a manifestation of the spirit of revelation in the name of Jesus. Let me add one last prayer point. Judgment upon the wicked, let it begin tonight. Some of you don't like the prayer, I say it again, judgment upon the wicked in the name of Jesus Christ. That every man, woman, boy and girl that partners with darkness to frustrate your destiny, may the God of vengeance arise. In the name of Jesus Christ. Wave your hands to Jesus. Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory.
Hello. Scriptures exhort us from the book of Proverbs. It says, my son, attend to my sayings. Incline thy ears to my words. Let them not depart from thy eyes, and keep them in the midst of thee. As you have listened to this message, we believe that you are going to reap the blessings thereof if you attend to these words as well. That you will keep these words in the midst of your heart. That no matter the circumstance, your eyes are going to be fixed on these words. And as you have been blessed, we will tell you to share this message. Be an evangelist by sharing to others to be blessed. And then subscribe to this channel for us, because we have loads of videos, we have loads of content that is going to make you blessed, that is going to set you on course, that is going to set you ablaze. And don't forget to like for us. Thank you.